Some trees have it hard. I'll give you all I've simply harbored. All that land and all that water for that one sweet plum. I'll give you all of Sydney Harbour, all that land and all that water for that one sweet promenade. Control's a major tone. Ground control's a major tone. Take your protein pills and put your helmets on. Ground control's a major tone. Commencing countdown, engines on. Check ignition and may God's love be with you. This is ground control to Major Tom. You've really made the grade. Now the Bedfords wanna know whose shirt you wear. Now it's time to reap the capture. This is Major Tom to ground control. I'm stepping through the door and I'm floating in the most peculiar way. And the star. I've crossed 100,000 miles. I'm feeling very still. And I think my spaceship knows which way to go. Tell my wife I love her very much. She knows. The ground control to Major Tom, your circuit's dead. There's something wrong. Can you hear me, Major Tom? Can you hear me? Can you hear me, Major Tom? Can you hear? Am I sitting in a tin can? Far above the world. Planets are this blue, and there's nothing I can do. took a man. Won't you hurry? 'Cause I'm tired of this scene. Farmer Blue Corn, won't you bring back all those colors to my dreams? Silver magic ships, you got red jumpers, coke, and sweet Mary Jane. Sugar man, metaphors written on a dusty, lonely road. Lost my heart when I found it. It had turned to deep black gold. Silver magic ships, you captured jumpers, coke, sweet Mary Jane. Sugar man, you're the answer. Makes my questions disappear. Sugar man, 'cause I'm weary of those double games I hear. Silver magic ships, you captain, jumpers, coke, sweet Mary Jane. Sugar man, 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 sugar man.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arrive. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird fly, blackbird fly into the light of a dark black night. Blackbird fly, blackbird fly into the light of a dark black night. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arrive. You were only waiting for this moment to arrive. You were only waiting for this moment to arrive. Thank you.
just because I love you, not because we're far apart. It's because I love you, and because you're in my heart. Do what you wanna do, be what you wanna be, yeah. Do what you wanna do, be what you wanna be, yeah, yeah. What you wanna do and be what you wanna be, yeah. It's because I love you, and because you love me too. It's because I love you, and because you always do. Do what you wanna do, be what you wanna be, yeah, yeah. Do what you wanna do, be what you wanna be, yeah, yeah. What you wanna do, be what you wanna be, yeah, yeah. Do what you wanna do, be what you wanna be, yeah, yeah. Do what you wanna do, be what you wanna be, yeah, yeah. Do what you wanna do, be what you wanna be.
Brush for fairy tales, itsy bits of diamond wells, big fat hurricanes, yellow belly giving names. Shortcuts can slow you down, but in the end we're bound to rebound off of a wave. We'll dust off your thinking caps, solar powered plastic lamps. Pretty pictures of things we ate, we're only what we make. But in the long run we have found, silence comes a full of sound, inaudibly free. Slow down everyone, you're moving too fast. Frames can't catch you when you're moving like this. Inaudible melodies of narrational strategies, unobtrusive tones help to notice nothing but the zone of visual relevancy. Frame lines tell me what to see, chopping like an axe. Well, maybe Einstein should just relax. Slow down everyone, you're moving too fast. Frames can't catch you and you're moving like this. Plato's cave is full of freaks demanding refunds for the things they've seen. I wish they could believe in all the things I've never
made the scene and just slow down. Everyone, you're moving too fast. Frames can't catch you when you're moving like this. And slow down, everyone, you're moving too fast. Frames can't catch you when you're moving like that, moving too fast. Sunshine where she's gone. It's not warm where she's away. There ain't no sunshine when she's gone. She's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Wonder this time where she's gone. Wonder if she's gonna stay. Rain or sunshine, which is gone. This house just ain't no home. Let it out, she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Sunshine where she's gone. Only darkness every day. Ain't no sunshine where she's gone. It's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away, yeah, yeah, yeah. Anytime she goes away. after all the jacks in the boxes. And the clouds have all gone to bed. You can hear happiness staggering on down the street. Footprints dressed in red. And the wind cries, Mary. A broom is dripping, sweeping up the broken pieces of yesterday's life. Somewhere a queen is weeping. Somewhere a king has no wife. And the wind screams, Mary. Traffic lights turn on blue tomorrow. Shining emptiness down on my bed. Yeah, tiny alley, boy's sides down the street. Because life in leaves was dead. And the wind cries, Mary. The wind never remember all the names it has blown in the past. With its crush, its old age, and its wisdom, whispers, no, this will be the last. And the wind cries, Mary.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the beautiful Adelaide Oval for the 2018 Magarey Medal and, of course, the West End South Australia Hall of Fame. It's going to be a fantastic night. Jarrod Walsh here for the live stream. This is going to be interesting. We'll see how it goes because we are live on social media and I can't see any of the comments which are coming in tonight. But in a second, we're going to find out what's going on the red carpet. But we thought we would get the man who knows everything about the SANFL, Zach Milbank, to say a few words because it's set to be not just an amazing SANFL match. League final series, but a really interesting count tonight, Zach.
Fascinating count, Jarrod. It's going to be interesting to see who ends up coming home with the Magarey medal. Of course, it's a very treasured night here on the SA football calendar. And could we see for the first time since 2002 two players from the same team take home the Magarey tonight? Jade Sheedy and Tim Weatherald were the last two to do that in 02. could we see Matt Panos and Mitch Grigg do the same thing from the Nord Footy Club? That's my little tip tonight.
It's always a risk because, of course, the incredible season that the Red Legs have had, they could take votes off one another, yes, and that makes some other players happy, like Nick Little from South and, of course, Zane Kirkwood, yep, who's already done it a couple of times. So it is going to be interesting to see. Do you have any dark horses for us?
I like Kane Stevens from West Adelaide as my dark horse because whenever Westies win, he plays exceptionally well. Gets a lot of the footy, he's flashy, carries the ball, kicks goals, which helps. James Boyd's the other interesting one from Woodville West Torrens. The Eagles never won a Magarey medal since the merger in 1991, Jarrod. So could we see James Boyd break that duck tonight?
Kane Stevens is allegedly a thief as well. We're going to chat to him on the red carpet later on tonight when he arrives, and we're going to find out whether he should be in prison tonight for stealing. So we'll find out a little bit about that. For those of you who didn't see the coverage over the weekend, the first weekend of the SANFL Maccas League finals, fascinating. Two completely different games with, I would say, unexpected results. An absolute blinder in the first one with North Adelaide getting the victory back in the finals for the first time since 2013, and then a really hard-fought effort from the Eagles to get the win over the reigning premiers.
That elimination final, Jarrod, that was an absolute cracker, just end-to-end stuff. The lead changed about three or four times in the last quarter, which was fantastic to see. We saw big Mitch Harvey kick four goals in that second term, almost the return of the genuine full forward, wasn't it? The way he burst through and took some marks and kick some nice set shot goals, and then just for them to outlast South Adelaide, that'll give them a lot of confidence going into the first semi this weekend against Sturt, I would have thought. And then, as you say, the other game, a real dour, hard fought contest, and we saw the Woodville West Torrens Footy Club strangle the life out of the reigning premier.
It was fascinating to watch, especially the performance of the Eagles, because we saw a couple of old campaigners like Paul Shield and Luke Thompson, but I paid close attention, like many others would have, to young Lukosha, so you can see why everybody's talking about him.
You can. And he played a bit of a different role in this game compared to the prelim final of last year when he made his Maccas League debut. This time he was higher up the ground. Got 18 disposals, 7 marks. Didn't quite hit the scoreboard. That's because he was further up the ground. Will he play the same role this weekend? It'll be interesting to see. And then how does Jarrod Cotton react in the coach's box for Nord as to who he places on him? Will it be an Alex Giorgio? Probably if he's deep. If he's up a bit higher on the ground, maybe a Ben Jeffries.
All right, so who has dressed you tonight? Because obviously we're looking at all the fabulously dressed people. I've done my hair for the occasion, and just a bit of warning, I'm not hydrated, so I may cough throughout the night. There's an earpiece falling out of my ear. Look at me, I'm an absolute mess. But you look beautiful, Zach. Who dressed you?
My wife, Sarah.
Fantastic.
Beautiful job. Thank you, Sarah. But I'm just missing the baseball cap, as are you.
Well, thanks for pointing that out. I really appreciate that. We'll check in with you a little bit later on. Of course, we are going to be chatting to a couple of the favourites and, of course, find out why Kane Stevens is a criminal and to see if Jarrod Ormond will still talk to me after I said his surname was Armand at the state team presentation. There's so much stuff happening tonight. We are going to have a sensational evening on the red carpet. Don't forget you can join in the conversation on social media as well. Zach, thank you very much, and we'll chat to you really soon.
Pleasure as always, Jarrod.
All right, see you later, Zach. Zach's going. So, as I said, it's going to be a lot of fun tonight. So get online on social media, join in the conversation, give all your feedback, let us know what you think of how people are dressing and stuff. No trolling. We're not about the trolling. We're about the love here at the SANFL, and we are about sharing the love, award winners, everybody getting around one another and just saying everybody looks beautiful. So we'll show you some more pictures of people arriving on the beautiful red carpet and have another very special guest in a couple of minutes.
Thank you. more, sorry, one more. Yeah.
This is very exciting, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, on the red carpet, reporting live, it is Jarrod here on Facebook. We've got three absolute legends with us tonight, including the Kiwi Farmer medalist. So thank you very much, Mark. Is that it? Great, good chat. Thank you very much for your time. It's been absolutely fantastic. Of course, you've got one of your teammates here. We're going to get to in a second. He's obviously notorious for being on television, especially after disturbing apprenticeships. We all have a really funny story here when it comes to this. Which two of you are physiotherapists? All right, you need a swap. We need a swap. I'm going to come to you in a second, Mark, all right? So, obviously, Chris came from Glenelg, coming here. You're a physio?
Oh, I was a physio, yeah.
Now, what's the story? Because you were obviously opponents, two Sturt players and a Glenelg player. Who was referred to go to the other person for some health advice?
Yeah, so I did physio with Chris. So Chris is one of my good mates and went through physio with him. And I guess I'd known Evo had been struggling with a hammy issue for a while. I'd known Chris had gone through it. And I think it would have been close to the end of pre-season, which I, you know, Evo and I were having a chat and I suggested he have a chat to Chris.
How did you go with that? Do you guys normally get along on the field? Did you know each other prior to this?
Well, probably, yeah, played on Chris a couple of times, but certainly good to reach out and get someone who's gone through a similar kind of injury to get his knowledge and, you know, really big help, I guess, at particularly leading into the season. So really appreciated his assistance.
Talk to me about grand final night, obviously a big celebration, but I was told to ask you about a beautiful show on Channel 7, and you can watch all the SANFL finals action on 7 as well, Sunrise. Remember, there could be kids watching, so be tame.
Yeah, so I think it was actually it was after Brewery Day on the Tuesday, so Wednesday morning, and just walking home and had my footy bag and premiership medal, etc., and just stumbled across a fire and... funnily enough, was the only person there, saw it just after it had just started and had to call it in, and I guess, yeah, the rest was on TV in the morning.
How are you guys feeling at the moment? Obviously, the weekend didn't go the way that you wanted, but the great thing is there's a double chance, and quite familiar in your road to premiership glory over the past couple of years, there has been a losing final, so that must give you some confidence going into this weekend.
Yeah, for sure. I think, you know, I was saying to Evo just then, we're in the exact same position as we were last year, and obviously, yeah, we'll look to make amends for last weekend, this weekend, and feeling good about it.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Congratulations again, Mark. I'm going to hang out with you for a sec. Keep going, guys. Have a selfie over on the red carpet. I'm going to continue with you. Chris, Glenelg, their season obviously not going the way that you wanted.
Yeah.
But what did you put in place, obviously, towards the back end of the year to look forward to 2019?
Well, we obviously finished pretty well. We went 6-0 to finish the year. And it was really just time, really, with Stoney. We didn't sort of have a coach until January, so we just needed a bit of time to put in place what he wanted us to roll out. And in the end, yeah, we were sort of all on the same page and just had some continuity with boys playing and, boys playing their roles, basically. So it just came out of time.
Are you a type of person who will sit down or come along to Adelaide Oval and watch your opponents play in the finals, or do you stay well away from watching football now?
Stay well away from that. I'll watch Sturt, though, to watch Crocs and Evo, but apart from that, probably won't come down. No Tanner Smith as well from North, so I might watch him run around, but a bit of jealousy when you switch on.
Now, it is Hall of Fame night tonight. True or false, Graham Corns, of course, Glenelg legend, is constantly at the club taking selfies in front of his gates and doing tours.
Exactly, yeah, I think it's true, actually. just parading around, as you should too. Absolute legend, that bloke.
All right, thank you very much for your time tonight. Go have a selfie and enjoy the night.
Thank you. Cheers.
See, this is what live streaming is all about. All right, we have a couple more representatives here. There's a man who may hate me, so I'm gonna leave him to the end. Come up here very quickly, guys. Tonight we have Mitch Clisby and, of course, Sarah. Is that right?
Yes, yes.
Fantastic. Who are you dressed by tonight? It's the first time I've said it.
Just a Shona Joy dress tonight.
Oh, yeah, Shona Joy, yeah.
You'd be familiar with that, I'm assuming.
Yeah, so familiar with Shona Joy. She does great things in the dress kind of things. Hey, Mitch, how are you going as well? Who's dressed you?
This is a Gibson suit, mate. Just thanks for asking. Who are you dressed by?
My mum. Thanks for asking as well. Great. A couple of years ago, I've had this suit in here for a while.
Good, mate. Well done. You look good.
Thank you so much. How's my hair?
Yeah, very good. What product are you using?
Well, I actually, funny story, and I'm glad you asked. It's like I set you up for this because there's two things. I shave my own head. So I hold like a handheld mirror while looking in my bathroom mirror. Can you tell me if I've missed a spot at the back? Because my missus didn't tell me last night. I've got a couple of moles there. Have a look.
No, you've done pretty well, mate. Well done.
Thank you so much. You're a fan?
Yeah, looks good.
Thank you. How are you guys feeling at the moment? Pretty positive going around. Interesting weekend of finals footy.
Yeah, it has been. Obviously, it's nice to win the first final and progress into this week's game. And a bit different for us. Past years, we've had a few beers tonight, but we'll be laying low tonight. So yeah.
Talk to me about Mitch Harvey. Fascinating to watch over the weekend, especially his second quarter. To watch the finals over the weekend, especially in the first game, I thought it was really interesting because no one was kicking goals at the northern end.
No, except for Mitch Harvey, four in the one quarter. Saw you pumping him up on Twitter. He's pretty happy with that. He's walking around the club last night with his chest out. And so, yeah, well done. You made his head even bigger.
Oh, great. Well, thank you. Thank you very much for your time. Go have a selfie, guys. I'm going to see how I go with this one now. Hey, mate, how are you?
Not too bad, mate. How are you going?
Yeah, good. Can you introduce yourself to the crowd watching?
I'm Jarrod Almond, not Almond.
Okay, so here's the deal. So it was the West End State Team dinner introduction, and I was a bit scatty. I had a big day at work. I've got a young daughter. She doesn't sleep. And then I've read it really quickly, and I've said it. And I felt horrible ever since, because as someone who talks on the microphone a lot, I like to make sure that I get names right. However, funnily enough, Jarrod, most of the people I spoke to afterwards said they have wrongly mispronounced your name as well.
Oh, it's happened since through kindy, through to high school, all through footy. Even commentators these days still get it wrong.
Does it annoy you?
A little bit.
Now, sorry, you guys married? Yes. Yeah, so you got the same surname, obviously. And I think you on Twitter, you had a crack as well.
Yes, I did.
So, when you went through the nuptials, did you have to have that big decision of going, well, far out, I'm going to get the Almond name?
Yes, I did, yes.
Now, I've been asked by someone who was in strength and conditioning. His name is Ben Brugman. And he said to say, hey, Nutsy, did your missus dress you tonight? Is this legit?
No, this is all me. The boys at Peter Jackson hooked me up. Old Eggs Benny. That's his nickname for the old Benny.
It's quite funny. I played hockey with Ben, and he played a couple of games, and then he retired.
Oh, well, it says a lot about him, doesn't it?
It does. All right, thank you very much, guys. Who are you dressed by tonight?
Hey, Kalesh Bridal.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to struggle with all that stuff. Jarrod Almond is here. Thank you very much, guys. I appreciate your time. It's fantastic. I can see Megahead Brett Ebert over there. He is an actual former Magarey medalist as well, so I should have some respect for Brett Ebert, dominating for the Henley Sharks. And if you were here at Adelaide Oval on Friday night, you would have seen him doing amazing things for the All-Stars in the EJ Witten Legends match. There's a lineup of people wanting to walk through. Have a look at him. We'll be back with our very special guest next. All right, Mr. Cameraman, come with us. We have a powerhouse couple of the SANFL. I'm talking about especially AFLW superstar Abby Holmes is here with her plus one tonight, Keegan Brooksby. Now, you guys look beautiful tonight. Abby, you always look beautiful. Usually, this is going to sound really weird, usually when people go, like, what sort of, like, athletic build do you want as a human being? I'll look at AFL players and stuff, but I go, far out, Abby, she works hard. Who are you dressed by tonight?
Oh, well, I have been dressed by the wonderful girls at One Night Stand tonight. They've looked after me really well. So, yeah, great bunch of girls down there.
Now, you've had a fantastic year, personally, but off the field as well, talking about your interest in the media, how much are you loving it? Because you're doing so much, which is brilliant.
Yeah, I love it. You know, I'm a bit of a footy head, so to, I guess, live my dream each and every day of just watching footy, talking footy, and really being in that football bubble, it's, it really is a dream come true for me. And, yeah, to be able to support Keegan tonight is pretty special as well.
So. How was it on the weekend? Was it tough to watch? Are you a good or a pretty tough supporter?
I was terrible on Sunday, but, you know, they gave it their all, and making finals is a brilliant achievement. And yeah, I think that they should be proud of what they have achieved this year.
Yeah, Keegan, really strange game to watch from a supporter's point of view, and I'm sure from a player's point of view, because it felt like obviously whoever was kicking towards the southern end in that last quarter was going to have the advantage, and it turned out that way.
Yeah, it was a bit strange because I suppose at three-quarter time we sort of had the momentum, and the win in the last quarter seemed to be going the other way as well. So credit to North, they played a fantastic four-quarter game and were able to get over us in the end.
Do you take out some positives though for next year, because obviously you're a highly supported club, finishing off the year strongly as well, and it can only mean good things for the club going into 2019?
Yeah, I think we've had a lot of younger guys come through, and that was their first taste of finals experience. Even the probably mid-tier players that have been around for a little bit haven't necessarily played a whole heap of finals. So to get that exposure, unfortunately didn't get the result, but I think that puts us in a good position for next year.
Do you love these nights? Because, of course, I'm working for SANFL TV here, so you have to say yes, but do you just have a look? Do you have a couple of quiet West Ends, or do you go, look, let's just have the dinner, hopefully the steak's decent size enough, and then we go home?
Oh, yeah, a little bit of that. I hope Nick Little gets the chockies at the end of the day, but it's also a good opportunity to see beautiful Abby dress up as well. So that's been something to be, I suppose, proud of as well.
You guys are so in love, and I love love. So, guys, go have some more photos, Abby and Keeks. Thank you very much, guys. Have a fantastic night. Very much appreciate it. See, how good is that? The power couple of the SANFL. Apparently, we got some more people coming as well. Just stay with me, because as I mentioned earlier, West Adelaide's Kane Stevens, there's rumours going around that he's a criminal, and he's brought his partner Macy Gibbs here with me. So, Kane, hello. How are you going?
Jarrod, good, thank you. How are you?
Yeah, feeling really good. Hey, Macy, how are you going?
Jarrod, good, thanks. How are you?
Yeah, good. Let's get the serious stuff out of the way first, because for any of South Australia police watching, Kane is indeed a criminal, because apparently he stole Bryce Gibbs' suit to wear tonight. Is that correct?
He lent it to me. I'll take it, though.
He lent it to you, because what I found out on social media today was that he's missing a suit, as opposed to he lent it to me.
Look, he might not have been home when I took it, but I've got a suit, so that's all that matters.
Okay, now, who's Macy wearing tonight?
That's a great question. I think he's wearing Bryce's fiancé's dress.
Macy, who are you wearing? Give him a plug.
I'm dressed by Lauren Sharkey tonight. Soon to be Lauren Gibbs. Actually, worn Nookie. Wearing Nookie.
Okay, fantastic. Now, the other thing about Macy is I've worded Macy up because she's got some great dad jokes, apparently. So drop a dad joke on us, and we'll see if everybody here laughs.
Okay, how did the butcher introduce his wife at the party?
How did the butcher introduce his wife at the party?
Meet Patty.
So funny. Can I ask a football question? Zach Milbank was pumping you up earlier. How do you rate your season, mate? Of course, selection in the West End State team, which I'm sure was a huge highlight for you personally.
Yeah, it was. Big privilege to play in that. Season's been all right. I'd rather win a few more games than we did this year, but it's always all right to play well. But yeah, I'm the stage of my career where I'd rather be playing finals than individual performance.
Did you belt someone this year or did you get rubbed out?
Yeah, in one of the trial games I accidentally bumped someone and got rubbed out.
I mean, if you accidentally bumped someone, you probably wouldn't have got rubbed out, I don't reckon.
Yeah, oh, I'm not sure. I'm not sure. No comment.
Do you get into nights like this tonight, mate? Obviously, you get to relax a little bit. As you said, it's a bit bittersweet because West Adelaide obviously aren't featuring, but it seems like it's going to be an interesting couple of weeks of finals football.
Yeah, I actually watched the finals on the weekend. It was really entertaining, so not sure who my tip is. I can't see anyone beating Norwood, but yeah, be good to watch the next few weeks.
Who's going to win tonight, Macy?
Kane Stevens.
Fantastic. And because, I mean, if you said you were going to win, it would be a little bit awkward. Who do you think's going to win?
I reckon Nick Little, South, my tip.
That's what big Keegan Brooksby just said as well. And Nick Little, his red hair is just on fire tonight.
Yeah, I think that's why he gets more votes, so might dye mine next year.
Okay, thank you very much, guys. Macy, leave us with one more dad joke.
What do you call a guy with no shins?
What do you call a guy with no shins?
Tony.
Good. That's good. So that's thanks, guys. Really appreciate that. That's the kind of quality we get here on the live stream of the 2018 Magarey Medal and, of course, the West End State Hall of Fame. It's full on. So just have a look. We'll see if Macy's telling him on his dad jokes, and we'll have some more guests very, very shortly. Well, this is very exciting here at the 2018 Magarey Medal. I am joined by a former Magarey medalist and a man who just dominates for the Henley Sharks Football Club at the moment, Brett Ebert. Mate, welcome. It was a while ago you won the Magarey. Do you feel old?
Yeah, I do. I think it's about 15 years ago. So actually, first time I've been back. So it's great to be back and support such a great event.
Really? This is your first time back to the Magarey?
Yeah, I'm a bit embarrassed. Dad's asked me every year and I should have shown more respect, and it's good to get here tonight and see what happens.
I still remember your speech, because obviously the Power were doing really well and you thanked Roger James because he told you to thank him on the night you won the Magarey. But looking back, obviously it's going to hold a special place in your family's history for a long time as well, with everything your father achieved.
Yeah, it certainly is. Obviously, with Dad winning so many, to follow in his footsteps was great, and to you know, over the years I've met a lot of the former winners that are Dad's mates, and just to be so young, to be 19 and win it, and to get back here tonight, I'm looking forward to seeing who wins it tonight.
Times have changed since you played for the Port Magpies. Of course, the power listed players there now, but yeah. It seems a really interesting year where a lot of those AFL boys players like Jack Trengove and Lindsay Thomas going back in leadership roles. So it shows that the club's still hanging around, and hopefully next year's not as disappointing as this one.
Yeah, obviously it was a tough year after making the grand final last year for the Magpies, and also the Power doing pretty well. It's disappointing for both teams, but it was great to draft some players that could actually play for the Magpies and be top up players and do really well and show the leadership on and off the field.
It shows through the man who has retired, Stephen Summerton. His career's been absolutely outstanding, and it shows that he lives and breathes the Port Adelaide Football Club.
Yeah, he's what a footy club's all about. A good St Michael's boy, like us, both of us. Really good school. And to hang around for that amount of time, and, you know, a lot of players will go to the country or, you know, get money somewhere else, to start the club for 200 games and, 12 or 13 seasons just shows what a person he is.
Just finally, there's a lot of conjecture about the head coach of the Magpies. His surname, obviously, we went to school with the man who lost his hair like I did, Matthew Locken. Now, we called him Loken at school, but he's referring to it as Locken?
I think it's Locken, yeah. I used to call him Gargamel, the guy that hunted the Smurfs. I don't think he likes that too.
Well, I mean, that's not very nice. And I remember Sam Newman actually once told him that his surname was Loken and that he was pronouncing it wrong.
Oh, yeah, I think it is Loken, but we've been Loken for many years now. So,
definitely. Mate, thank you very much for taking the time. This was unplanned. I went to watch you for the Henley Sharks. Are you guys still in or what?
No, we finished eighth, which is quite disappointing. But
good. Well, I'm sorry for asking.
Yeah, thanks.
Mate, former Magarey medalist Brett Ebert, legend of the Port Adelaide Football Club. All the best, mate.
Thanks, mate. Thanks, Walshy.
We're live as well, so I can't shake your hand or hug or anything. I just go, yeah, thanks. All right, thank you very much. Brett Ebert is an absolute legend as well for all of you Port Adelaide Football Club people watching. We got some people watching this stream tonight, which is brilliant. Hello to my mum, my uncle, my auntie, my wife, my dog, who I've taught how to use the internet as well. We have Trent Goodrum here, who's going to come up from Centrals. Hello, Trent. How are you, mate?
Very well, thank you.
Thank you very much for taking the time to have a chat. Who are you dressed by tonight? Because we've come dressed the same.
My wife, she usually dresses me. She's definitely got the fashion sense in the family.
Talk to me about the season for the Doggies.
A bit of a frustrating one and a tough one. As you can see, not playing finals this year is pretty disappointing. But hopefully tonight we can enjoy it. And hopefully Travis Schiller has had an exceptional year. So let's hope he is up there in the count.
It's going to be interesting because obviously the two boys from Norwood may take votes off one another, so we could have some standouts. We could see Schiller do really well. We could see Nick Little as well, so it could be his year.
Yeah, definitely, and I don't think there's too many boys at Centrals will take too many votes off Trav, so I definitely won't be, so fingers crossed for him.
Wanted to ask you quickly about finals. I'm sure it is really frustrating because for the past 15, 20 years, we have just thought Centrals play finals and they win finals, and to be in this position now, how are you watching the finals?
I probably won't watch too much. I get a bit jealous of other people and their success. Knowing that we're not out there as a club is, it's hard to swallow, I guess, when you're competitive and successful for so long. To not be there and not be in it, yeah, I don't know how to act, really.
All right, good luck for Travis. Keep him in check, of course, because obviously with something like this, is he got a pre-prepared speech, just in case, you reckon?
I don't know. He's pretty humble. He's probably just sitting there and just trying to stay away from the limelight.
Because it looks like Mitch Griggs had four spray tans.
Well, Griggy's probably prepared for it, and he probably deserves to be, I think.
All right, well, mate, thank you very much for your time, Trent. Really appreciate it, mate, and all the best to Centrals for next year.
No worries, thank you.
All right, all the best. Trent Goodrum there, leader of the Central Districts Football Club. We're going to have a keep looking around and seeing all the people arriving. It's going to be a sensation, right? We'll cross to the actual event very soon as well. You can check it out on 7, mate, and then we'll chuck it onto 7. So thank you very much for watching the stream. We'll show you some more pictures and come back with another special guest in a few minutes.
Nice to meet you. Oh, we need to put this. Oh,
Ladies and gentlemen, watching the stream for the 2018 SANFL Magarey Medal, I want to make sure I say your surname right. Alex Arricchio, am I saying it correctly?
Yeah, that's spot on right there, mate. Good job.
Okay, now this is fantastic because I don't know too much about you, and I love men from the United States of America. Accent, American sport, all this stuff. How long have you been in Australia for? This is your second year for the Panthers, right?
4 years now, yeah, second year for the Panthers. It's pretty funny, actually, in Adelaide. Speaking of accents, everyone thinks I'm from Ireland, so I haven't got that wrapped around my head yet. I don't know how they do, but accents interesting, I guess.
What actually brought you here?
Aussie rules.
So are you following in the footsteps of seeing players like Mason Cox obviously doing well, Jason Holmes, who was at St Kilda in the AFL, that's really working out?
Yeah, no, that's the goal, is to make my way and try and get drafted into the AFL, and just trying to work hard every day to maybe go on an opportunity at some point, but it's been a lot of fun. It's been a great adventure so far, and just looking to continue to build on it and keep moving forward.
What's been the hardest thing to learn about Australian rules football?
What isn't the hardest thing? I guess it's more like it. Just the timing, knowing where to run, when to run, and just building the camaraderie with teammates and the kicking, and there's so many technicalities to it, and I think I learn a new rule every game just by breaking the rules. So there's a lot that goes into it, but every day, keep an open mind and roll with it.
Awesome, and I love that you've adopted the Australian mullet for tonight as well. Is this intentional?
Not at the start. It's kind of taken on its own life of its own. So it's been fun. Everyone's gotten around it, and it's been a pretty funny couple months with it, to be honest.
Just finally, a non-football related question: whereabouts in the States are you from?
New York, born and raised.
Okay, so do you think that LeBron can take the Lakers to the NBA Finals, or do you think they'll struggle in the Western Conference Finals?
No, the Knicks all day, baby, Knicks.
The Knicks are the worst team in the NBA, apart from Porzingis.
No comment on that one.
All right, well, mate, all the best for next year. Welcome to Australia. You've been here for a while, but continue developing, man, and hopefully we can see your name in bright light soon.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
It's been fantastic. Go have your selfie with your teammates as well. This is awesome. See, we're getting to know all the players from the SANFL, their partners as well. We're going to throw to Sodas in a second as well, who is going to get through all of the formalities. I'm obviously not very formal because my earpiece is falling out and all that stuff, so we'll cross to him in a couple of minutes. We've been live on the red carpet. Well, this has been fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. Just the ultimate red carpet experience. Now, Zach, you would have seen me speaking to all of these players. Young Arricchio, mate, he's fascinating. He's a big unit. How old is he, you reckon?
He's about sort of 23, 24-ish, Jarrod. He's actually played with Carlton in the VFL for a couple of years before he came out here to SA and trying his luck with the Panthers. But this year in particular, he's made giant strides in terms of his ruck craft. He's really starting to palm the ball nicely to his teammates, and he's even hit the scoreboard a couple of times with a couple of goals this year, so it's great to see. Fantastic.
You are my date for the night. We're going to go in and we are going to throw live to Mark Soderstrom. Enjoy the coverage and we'll chat really soon.
Say Footy Commission, the SANFL League Directors, Club President, CEOs, welcome along. Also, we'd like to thank SANFL's key corporate partners, SANFL's major partner West End, who have been involved since 1954. The guys from West End are here, Jason Bailey and crew. Also to Russell Gallagher and Serafino, our wine sponsor, so make sure you get a couple of glasses of that to warm you up. Paul Childs and the crew from Channel 7, Andy Kay as well from Channel 7, great to have all of you here involved with the broadcast a little later on in the evening. And also Flight Centre, now this is fantastic, the Magarey medalist will pick up a Flight Centre voucher to be able to head across the world and celebrate, so Felicity Allen is here from Flight Centre. Okay, formalities out of the way. Please put your hands together and welcome the Chairman of the South Australian Football Commission, the Honourable John Olsen, to officially welcome you all here.
Thank you, Mark. A short walk from where we are here tonight, just behind the northwestern corner of this iconic stadium, is a very special place for South Australian football. Along a tree-lined pathway lie the names of some greats of Australian football. It's an inspiring stroll through times as names leap out from the past, like Norwood's Albie Green, South Adelaide's Don Moriarty, Eagles' Bob Hank, Sturt's Len Fitzgerald, Port Adelaide's Trevor Obst, Central's Gary Window, Glenelg's Fred Phillis, North's Barry Robran, West's Ken Eustace, and many others, all immortalised in Magarey Grove, relocated from Westlakes Boulevard and reborn here at the new home of football in South Australia. Those plaques recording their names and lasting legacy and contribution to Aussie rules football here in South Australia. The Magarey Medal is Australia's oldest individual football award or honour. And tonight, we're here to add another name to the distinguished list of some 120 Magarey medalists. Your Excellency, Minister Wingard, Katrine Hilliard, Member of Parliament, welcome to the 2018 South Australian Hall of Fame presentation and Mary Magarey Medal presentation. A night of recognition, celebration of football in this state, showcased by a live broadcast by Channel 7 around the state and supported strongly by the advertiser. And tonight, we will induct three new members into the South Australian Football Hall of Fame. They will join some 211 players, coaches, umpires, administrators, and media representatives who have been recognised for their contribution to the game. And I want to acknowledge and thank the Hall of Fame Selection Committee and Lee Wicker, John Halbert, Neil Curley, Chris McDermott, David Shipway, Michelangelo Rucci, Bill Sanders, Julian Burton, and Tim Pfeiffer. Thank you for your efforts on our behalf. While tonight is about recognising great achievements, past and present, it's also equally important for us to focus on the future. For any young footballer, seeing the Magarey Medal recipients and Hall of Fame inductees is inspirational. It gives them something to aspire to. And that's why SANFL dedicates huge energy, resources, and experience in developing talent pathways across our state. That's why the Commission has integrated Metro Juniors and the community football into the SANFL family. A further example is the expansion of the statewide Super SANFL Women's League from 4 teams last year, 6 teams this year, to 8 teams next year, which, I hasten to add, has the largest prize pool of any women's state league competition in Australia. We've recorded constant growth in AusKick registrations, passing 10,000 for the first time. Our SANFL Juniors competitions continue to grow from strength to strength. And we've coached more coaches and umpires than ever before and extended our reach into Indigenous communities in this state. We're number one in Australia, and let me emphasise, above and beyond any other state in Australia, for participation in club-based team sport. South Australia holds that record. But football is about much more than simply numbers. We hosted a game of participants from Down Syndrome South Australia during the halftime break at Port Adelaide St Kilda match in round 16. Playing on the deck of AFL and SANFL teams of these young, challenged people had to be seen to be believed. Just how good is that for these young people? The excitement in their faces and playing on that deck where their heroes played. For them and their families, that's invaluable. And that shows once again how footy brings people together, combining passion and compassion, and why our game is the heartbeat of so many communities across our state. And in that context, I want to recognise and thank the thousands of volunteers to make this great game possible in South Australia. Our SANFL clubs, of course, are essential to our talent pathways, and I'd like to thank them for their contribution in providing structure, resources, guidance and opportunities for young South Australians to participate in Aussie rules footy. To the player or players, fortunate enough to be awarded the Magarey Medal this year, you can take pride in knowing you are truly the fairest and most brilliant player amongst your peers. Tonight, we will celebrate your achievement. Please enjoy the evening here at the Magarey Medal and South Australian Hall of Fame presentation 2018. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you, John. Congratulations on leading the Commission, navigating them through what we've got in 2018 so far. Of course, finals still to go with the SANFL, of course, getting underway next Sunday coming up. Of course, we've got another couple of doubleheaders after we had the elimination final and the qualifying final on the Sunday gone. Before we get into our first awards, if you're involved in a bit of social media, the hashtag for tonight is hashtag Magarey Moments. If you don't know what I'm talking about, don't even worry about it. Those that do know about it will be understanding that and tweeting. And if you're really keen, just ask someone a little younger than yourself if you're not sure, and they'll be able to guide you through if you want to put things on Insta and Facebook and anything else like that, Snapchat or Tinder. I'm not quite sure how it all works. Let's get into our first awards for the night. Now, John did touch on this. We talked about the SANFL Statewide Super Volunteer of the Year. It was last year that it was introduced. And what we're doing is highlighting the people that do wonderful things for football right across the community and that are doing it off their own bat. They are the people that probably got us all involved in football at some stage in our lives to start with. SANFL and Statewide Super have joined forces to recognise these local legends, and they do great work behind the scenes. The help of volunteers ensures that footy remains strong in our community. The winner of the SANFL Statewide Super Volunteer of the Year will also be named the AFL State Volunteer of the Year and be presented for the very first time the David Shipway Medal. Shippy, where are you in the room? Where are you, Shippy? Shippy, how are you, mate? Great to see you. David Shipway retired recently after, well, nearly 30 years of service to football in South Australia on the Commission and particularly in the country region. So, Shippy, great to have you here, and I think it's a great recognition that the medal is named after you. So, mate, you can just stand up here and relax, give all these awards out. We're going to meet our eight finalists now, and then we'll have our winner. All righty, before we do that, I'd just like to ask that Richard Nunn comes up and joins us. He is the CEO of Statewide Super. Richard, if you'd like to make your way up, because along with Shippy, you'll be doing the presentations. Thank you to Statewide Super for your support. Let's roll straight into it. Finalist number one from Crystal Brook Footy Club, Michael Fogarty. Congratulations, Michael, if you'd like to come up and grab a certificate. More than 24 years of outstanding service there. He's been doing everything from coaching to working as a trainer, and he certainly helped Crystal Brook with their membership growth. So well done, Michael. Finalist number two, Julie Fox, Jervois Combined Sports Club. 10 years of service at Jervois. Julie's been a Canteer volunteer. Importantly, now everyone that's played footy in winter knows what you need. Julie cooks the soup for the players when they come off the track on training nights, a very important role, contributing many hours of volunteer work and looking after the Junior Competition Council. So well done, Jules. Karen McCloy, Rosewater Footy Club, 6 years of dedicated work there, looking after the junior players, equipment coordinator, Auskick coordinator as well. And what about this? For some of the kids that have been struggling to pay their fees, Karen's put her hand in her own pocket to help pay the fees of some of the kids. So that is fantastic, Karen. and also introduce the healthy options in the club canteen on game day. I hope they still have the lolly snakes for the younger kids, but they had healthy options as well. So well done to you, Karen. Sax Seagate from the Boston Football Club. Sax has been an Auskick coordinator, team coach, committee member, 10 years of service, and has grown the junior numbers as president of the junior team. Good on you, Sax. Well done. Finalist number 5, Darcy Springhall from Strathalbyn Footy Club. Darcy, 20 years of dedicated service. Darcy's been a committee member, a runner, timekeeper, umpire, equipment coordinator, and importantly, introduced women's footy to the club. So well done, Darcy. Finalist number 6, just a couple more to go, Kim Steer from the Brighton Football Club. 19 years of great work from Kim. He also introduced women's footy to the club. And what about this? Live streaming and commentary of all the games on Facebook, so you can stay in touch. Kim's been a coach, a runner, he's manned the canteen, and importantly the bar, looked after a lot of fundraising as well, and has helped Brighton move into the Adelaide Football League. Finalist number 7, 2 to go, Michael Trentafalakis, who is the community ambassador. He's been pivotal in his role of the Welcome to Australian Rules football program for multicultural kids. How good's that? Teaching migrant students about the great game of footy and also teaching other kids about multiculturalism in Australia. Get that one out early. And our final finalist, last and certainly not least, Adrian Waite, who's made the trip over from Peak and Districts Footy Club. Good on you, Adrian. 15 years, he's a club senior trainer, mentors all the club's junior trainers, and looks after a lot of the injury management going above and beyond for everyone involved in the Peak and Districts Footy Club. So congratulations to all of our finalists. Now, to announce who is the actual winner, I'd like to invite Richard Nunn, CEO of Statewide Super, up, who are wonderful supporters of SANFL.
I'm very, very pleased to announce the winner of the David Shipway Medal and 2018 SANFL Statewide Super Volunteer of the Year is Michael Fogarty from Crystal Brook Football Club.
Congratulations to Michael. As we said, 24 years he's been helping out at Crystal Brook as a coach, a trainer, and he is the first recipient of the David Shipway Medal. How's that, Shippy? You got a medal named after you. Amazing, but great work by Shippy. Yes, well, Shippy, it's not the Memorial Medal, so be grateful. All righty, Michael, come over here, mate. Congratulations, Michael. How are you? I'll just bring these down a little bit for you, buddy.
Yeah, good, thanks, Mark.
How you going? Have a look at this. Mate, you're at the Magarey Medal, getting an award around your neck. It's not the Magarey Medal.
No.
But I'll tell you what, Michael, it's not too bad.
No, I'd just like to thank the SANFL and Statewide Super for making this award available to the volunteers. I do know more than all those other nominees and all those volunteers out there. I was just lucky enough to be picked, Mark.
Michael, give us a quick rundown. The roles that you've had at the club over the years. You've been a coach? Trainer?
Trainer.
What else?
President, delegate of the association, help out of the association as a trainer sometimes, and yeah.
Good on you, mate. You get great support from the other fellow volunteers at Crystal Brook?
Yeah, great bunch of men and women, and you know, the women behind the club, they're the unsung heroes of footy clubs, I reckon.
Good on you, Mike. Anyone else you want to thank?
I'd just like to thank my family and my nominees, the Crystal Brook Football Club and the Northern Areas Football Association. I've been involved with them all my life, having been born and bred in Georgetown and played for Georgetown, Gedowie, Gladstone and Combine over the Brook the last 24 years. So I've been in Northern Areas all my life and it's a great association.
Congratulations, Michael Fogarty. Well done, buddy. Fantastic. Thank you to David Shipway and also to State for Richard Nunn for their great work. Alrighty, we are now going to go into our first of our fairest and most brilliant awards for the evening. Just to give you an understanding, if you haven't been to this night before, it's returned to TV, which is fantastic, on 7. So at 9 o'clock tonight when we start the count, we're going to go on 7, mate. But around about 9:30, 9:40, we're going to switch over to the main channel once the front bar has finished. So if you've got anyone at home that wants to know, make sure, I'll let you know when it is, but we are going to switch over to the main channel, so hopefully we get a big audience too from the front bar in as well, which will be terrific. So what we are going to do now, though, is present our underage and reserves medals. So our best and fairest for the under 18, the SANFL Torrens University Cup under 18 competition is the McKellen's Tompkins medal, which some of you that are a little more senior in the room will remember the McKellen medal and the Tompkins medal were the two medals for the 17s and 19s now combined since we've been in the under 18s over the past few years. Not only the medal, but a $1,000 travel voucher to the Magarey medal prize partner. Flight Centre is going to provide that as well. Brendan Phillips, where are you? Sticko, 1993 Magarey medalist, SANFL State Talent Manager. Well done to Sticko and his crew too. The under-18s, the under-16s won the national championships. Under your beautiful tutelage, Brenton, well done. Great to see you here again. And our winner of the McKellen Tompkins medal for 2018 from Woodville West Torrens, Kai Pudney. Congratulations to Kai. Kai played in the SA under-18s just recently. 23 votes he picked up in this competition to win by 3 over Kay Chandler and North Adelaide's Bailey Coleman Oaks. Well done, Kai. We'll bring him over here. Hello, mate. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Please give Kai a round of applause. All right, Kai, come up here, mate. How you doing? All right.
All right.
Are you nervous?
A little bit.
You shouldn't be nervous. Excuse me. We just have a little bit of quiet at the back. Thank you kindly. That's great. Kai, congratulations, mate. You don't need to be nervous. Yeah. Mate, you've won the fairest and most brilliant player in the under-18s competition. And not only that, your season's still alive at the moment, isn't it? Straight into the grand final?
Yeah.
Tell us about the weekend.
We got a bit lucky. We were losing by a bit 5 minutes ago, but we snagged the win, which is good.
3 goals down with 8 minutes to go, and you've pulled one out, haven't you?
Yeah.
Were you involved heavily in the quick change to get everyone back?
Oh, I think it was a team effort. We all played well together, yeah.
Jeez, saying the right things. Your coach, Shane Reardon, will be very happy to hear that, Kai. Now, one thing I think is fantastic people won't be aware of, you're part of the Next Generation Academy at the Port Adelaide Football Club because one of your parents was born overseas. So, Mum.
Yeah.
So, where's Mum from originally?
Mum was born in Japan, yeah.
Was she?
Yeah.
You were born in Australia?
Yeah.
Does Mum still speak fluent Japanese?
Yeah, I think she can.
Give us a little bit of Japanese, Kai. What do you
really
got?
Don't really have much.
Come on, you got to have something.
Don't really have anything, nah.
Mate, konnichiwa. Yeah, sorry, have you got nothing?
Yeah, nah, not really.
Sushi.
Yeah,
sorry. Kai, you've let me down. Yeah. Mate, tell us about the port. What you've been doing at Port Adelaide, because you've been working, I think, with Matty Broadbent and a few others.
Yeah, I get to train there a little bit throughout the pre-season and once a week during the week, which is good. Good opportunity.
Mate, this is fantastic. So what happens now coming draft time, because you played in the state under-18s, Kai fits into the same sort of system they do with the father-son picks, so that anyone wants to bid for you, Port Adelaide gets the right because they've had you in the academy to take you and match that bid.
Yeah.
They've been in your ear a little bit, Chris Davies and the crew,
not
Jeff
really.
Parker?
Nothing much.
Do you want to put in a bit of a word tonight?
I'll be all right. No.
I reckon you'll be all right. Now, one thing I need to check too, the world in football is changing rapidly, right? Now, we thought an out-there haircut was like the mullet that Stephen Kernaghan sort of sported in the 80s, but there's a lot of man bun action going on at SANFL level at all ages.
Yeah.
You've got one going. Now, I want to know why you wear the man bun at training, but you smear Grippo in your hair during the games to keep your hair down and you don't go for the man bun in the games. Are you not bold enough?
Yeah, I reckon just hair down looks better, so, yeah.
You've never sported the man bun in a game?
No.
Do blokes get into you about the hair?
I think they probably think it's a bit disgusting, but, yeah.
You know the good thing is, though, mate, you let your football do the talking.
Yeah.
Because you're averaging something like 30 touches a game and you're into a grand final and you now are a medalist. Did you bring a date tonight?
Yeah, I brought a teammate.
Did you?
Yeah.
What's his name?
Sam Michael.
Sam, where's Sam?
Over there.
Sam, how are you, buddy? Well done into the grand final. You get a $1,000 voucher from Flight Centre. Where will you and Sam be going off to?
I don't know. I don't mind. I'll take the boys somewhere.
Do you reckon you'll take Sam?
Yeah, I'll take the under-18 boys, yeah.
Concentrate on your footy. The girlfriends will come later, mate.
Yeah, cheers.
Congratulations. Is there anyone you'd like to thank?
Yeah, I'd like to thank the Woodville West Torrens Football Club for giving me a great opportunity. I'd like to thank all the coaches, especially Shane Reardon. I'd like to thank all my teammates, all the support staff, and my family and friends. Yeah, that'd be it.
Good on you, mate.
Cheers.
Well done. Congratulations, Kai. Beautiful stuff. And thank you to Brenton Phillips. Good on you, mate. And we look forward to seeing your name come out. And as we said, Kai played in the state under-18s that won the national championships under Tony Bamford, which is absolutely magnificent. We'll hear a little bit more about that as we go through the night. All right, time for the reserves Magarey medal. Player judged best and fairest in the twos, $2,000 voucher. So hopefully our next winner will be happy to take their partner, like Kai, away. South Australian Minister for Recreation and Sport is the Honourable Corey Wingard. Corey, just as you're about to pour yourself a little wine, I'd like to ask you to come up here right now, mate. Good to see you looking after Serafino. Come up here and present the medal. Congratulations to the winner from the Central District Footy Club, Jacob Templeton. Jacob came home very, very hard in the competition with a couple of big games, and he snuck in with 16 votes and knocked off Woodville West Torrens Rover James Rowe by one vote. So well done to Jacob from the Doggies. Jacob, how are you, man?
I'm good, yourself.
You going well? Step up, big man. Step up. All right. Now, your past couple of games, your season's still alive too, which we'll get to in a moment. Past couple of games, obviously very nice. 5 goals in round 18. Get the 3 votes?
I hope so.
Probably deserve them. And then backed up again, 25 touches in the last round, and you've beat Rowey by one vote.
Yeah, I'm not sure how close it was at the end, but it sounds like I might have just got him. We played them in the last round as well, so.
Oh, you got him.
I got him
beautifully.
In the last game.
You got him in the last round too?
Yeah.
Elimination final, got through on the weekend?
Yeah, we didn't play overly well, but we were lucky enough we've ended up with a fairly strong team towards the end of the year. But yeah, it was a bit scrappy, we got it done, but we had to win our last 4 games to get in the finals anyway, so we've been fighting for a few weeks now.
Good on you, mate. Now, we know that you're at Central.
Yep.
Went to the Eagles for a little while, then came back to Central.
Yep.
Tell us about the move and the change. Why go there, then come back?
On the way back, I went over to Eagles for a couple of years.
Yep.
At the time, I almost went back to basketball. So I sort of, I've tossed and turned a few times. Obviously, I come across from basketball in 2011. So there's been a few times where I've thought about going back. It was going quite well when I finished at the time. So there's been a few times I thought about going back, but things just sort of fell that way. I was still training our reserves coach, Jeff Brown.
Yes.
So he was in my ear a little bit just before I sort of pulled the pin, went back to basketball, sort of.
And you train him because you run a gym?
Yeah, I just opened my own gym this year.
Beautiful. What's it called?
It's JT Performance.
JT Performance, give it a plug. Personal training?
I've got a couple of others on board now as well, so we got physio and stuff too, so
yep.
It's not just myself.
And whereabouts if someone's looking to get themselves in shape?
It's in Golden Grove.
Beautiful. And $2,000 from Flight Centre. I've got to ask because I was interested to see what Kai was doing. It would be remiss of me not to ask you. Partner tonight?
No, I came with Kyle Presbury.
Kyle's going to have a nice trip. There he is. He's happy. Just floating single at the moment?
Yep. That's why I had to scrape the barrel and bring Kyle.
You were... When you're very professional with the training, no fishing off the company jetty?
No.
Good boy. Make sure you don't get caught up in that, mate. I'm sure there's some people you'd like to thank, and good luck against the Bays this week.
No worries, thanks. I'd just like to thank reserves coach Darren Reeves. He's been very supportive to me on and off the field this year, just for him giving me an opportunity to play through the midfield this year as well and prove myself. Just like to thank my teammates, obviously still in finals. Hopefully we can have a good run over the next few weeks and go fairly deep into the finals. Probably just want to thank Daniel Bell, our head trainer. He does a lot for me off the field as well, sort of behind the scenes. Lucky enough to not be too injured this year, which was good, but he still does a lot for me regardless. Also like to thank the club as well. They were pretty understanding of my situation this year with the gym. I probably couldn't commit to training quite as much as I would have liked this year, but we sort of sorted it out and probably allowed me to play again this year, which was great. And probably just to my family for the support. Probably my parents in particular still make it out to every single game, regardless what grade I'm playing or where we are. So I really appreciate their support. And good luck to everybody in the count tonight.
Jacob Templeton, congratulations, mate. Well done, and good luck on the weekend. Taking on Glenelg in the first semi-final. I'd like to, we did mention our key partners before. Of course, Serafino are involved. Also, West End, who have been great supporters for many years as well. Flight Centre and Channel 7, who are looking after the broadcast tonight. There are some key corporate partners I'd also like to acknowledge who have done some great things with SANFL and supported them out. Many of the guests are here tonight. So to Peter Russo from McDonald's, welcome along. Jarrod Mortimer from Coca-Cola Amatil. Richard Nunn, who we saw before from Statewide Super CEO there. Andy Kay from Channel 7, our general manager there. Brad Mills of National Pharmacies Optical, who sponsor the umpires, which is very appropriate. Sam Parkinson representing Burley Seacombe. David Brownie from Bank SA. Mourne Team, Mike Perry, the business development manager. Mike is here. And also APN Outdoor, Annalise Norsworthy, who is the account manager. So again, thank you very much to all of those organisations that support football in this state. We're going to take a break now for main course. The Happy Leonards will perform to keep you going. And then after that, we're going to have our three inductions into the West End South Australian Football Hall of Fame. Enjoy your main course.
Can't get to sleep. I think about the implications of diving in too deep, and possibly the complications, especially at night. I worry over situations. I know I'll be alright. Perhaps it's just imagination. Day after day reappears, but night after night my heartbeat shows the fear. Ghosts appear and fade away. Alone between the sheets only brings exasperation. It's time to walk the streets, smell the desperation. At least there's pretty lights, although there's little variation. It nullifies the night from overkill. Day after day it reappears, night after night my heartbeat shows the fear. Ghosts appear and fade away. Come back another day. I can't get to sleep. I think about the implications of diving in too deep, and possibly the complications, especially at night. I worry over situations I know will be alright. It's just overkill. Day after day it reappears, but night after night my heartbeat shows the fear. Ghosts appear and fade away. Ghosts disappear and fade away. Ghosts appear and fade away.
Well, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We've gone straight from the red carpet, and we are live now in the beautiful room. It looks incredible. Zane Kirkwood, I am joined with, mate. Obviously, the result didn't go the way of the Double Blues on the weekend, but I was speaking earlier outside. You boys know how to lose a final and then win lots of them.
Yeah, I guess that's something we can take, as we've lost one in each last two. But, yeah, it's obviously not what you want to do. That's not the best prep. But, yeah, we're looking to try and bounce back this week.
Did you expect the Eagles to come out and do what they did? It was such a fascinating game to watch.
Yeah, we knew they'd have a crack. There was a bit of a build-up to it as well. And so they played really well. Credit to them. They deserve to win. So, yeah, they did well. So we've just got to find what we did wrong and try and bounce back.
Now, you know what these nights are all about. You've won a couple of them. Any advice if they came up to you and said, you know what, Zane, what do we do if it was Nick Little, if it was Mitch Grigg, who's definitely on the waters tonight? Are you just take your time because you might have to do some serious stuff later?
Yeah, just enjoy it. Enjoy the night. It's been a blur the other time, so just take it all in and say g'day to everyone and, yeah, enjoy it.
Double Blues have had a sensational year once again. A couple more finals to go. How are you preparing this week? Because it's going to be a tough opposition.
It is. North are playing really well. They played well on the weekend. So, we're preparing as per normal. Just got to bring a better effort. I think we were a bit down on the weekend, so really crack in and get into it.
Seems like you get asked this question every year, but your head coach is one of the most sought-after coaches in Australia at the moment, so he seems to be still enjoying his time at Sturt no matter what happens afterwards.
Yeah, Moose is he's a footy nut. He loves it, and Sturt through and through, so he's really good. But, yeah, whatever happens with him is good. It's been great so far, so hopefully he stays, but I don't think he will. But see how we go.
Do you reckon the season's gone fast? Because I remember speaking to you at SANFL Fast Footy. We played at the parade at the start of the year, and here we are at the Magarey. Like, it's just flown.
I think I was a bit rude to you that night, so sorry, mate.
You weren't mean it. Oh, no, it was fantastic. I didn't mind.
It's gone so quick. Yeah, I even think of the start of pre-season to now. There's only a couple of weeks left if you get to the grand final. So, it's definitely flown by. So.
Right, give me a tip for tonight. We need a winner.
All right. I reckon a draw with Nick Little and Matty Panos.
That'd be fantastic. And I was saying earlier, Nick Little gets votes because he's got a bit of a blood nut head.
That's, it works, yeah. It's,
I said that. I can say that because I'm bald. Like, I can say that. I don't get a choice. Mate, thank you very much for all your time. You're a fantastic leader, Sturt, and you do amazing things for the SANFL. So you can enjoy tonight.
Beauty. Thanks, mate. Cheers.
Zane Kirkwood is still going to get lots of votes tonight as well, ladies and gentlemen, here at the count. So we are going to have a walk around. We're going to actually sitting next to Zane. And sitting next to Zane is Brooke Chaplin. Let's actually go over here and have a chat to Brooke. Brooke Chaplin, hello, how are you?
Hey, I'm good, thank you, how are you?
Yeah, good. Now, who has dressed you tonight?
So this is just a hire from Ons, but it's a Lexi dress.
Can I be honest with you? When I ask that question, I don't know anything when they say, yeah, I'm dressed by old mate. I have no idea.
No, I didn't either until I got asked last year, and I was like, I don't actually know. So I did a little bit of research.
Fantastic. Talk to me about this incredible football club.
Oh, it's amazing. It is, yeah. It's just a great club to be a part of. It's like a big country club. Everyone loves everyone, and yeah, it's good.
I was talking to Zane earlier saying that Sturt have a fascinating way in the men's competition of losing a final and then just winning all of them. So yeah. He seems in pretty good spirits at the moment too.
Yeah, no, he is. It's, yeah. He's not worried, I'm not worried. Well, he might be worried, but he pretends he's not.
Do you like nights like this? Because having a look around, people get to dress up. There's nervous people. I said earlier, Mitch Griggs had a couple of spray tans and he's on the waters right now. Of course, Nick Little as well. Panos is wondering if Griggs going to steal his votes. They have to be nervous. Petrenko's looking at things going, what can I build? So do you get into these nights?
Nice, but I find them really stressful. I'm not really big on getting done up too much, so it's, yeah, it's good to, once you're here, but getting ready is always stressful, so.
Well, it took me about 4 hours to get ready because I've got a golden retriever at home, so I had to go today and buy like a delinter. You look absolutely beautiful. I've got body butter on my head so it doesn't get shiny, so I'm going through a midlife crisis. Strawberry body butter, okay? Is that what you're doing as well, Zane?
I've actually got that brand at home, so what I might do is I might pop it on Zane because your head looks really nice.
Thank you so much.
He needs a bit of it too.
Yeah, I reckon he's got a bit to go though. I reckon Zane's going well with his head.
Yeah, I have to shave it weekly, but nah, it's not too bad, is it?
I had to ask people on the red carpet tonight because I hold a mirror while looking at my bathroom mirror at the back of my head, and my wife didn't see last night, so I may have random bits of hair at the back of my head and no one's told me. So if I look like a creep tonight, guys, that's the look I'm going for. I'm going to let you eat your dinner. Sorry for taking so much of your time, Brooke. It's lovely to meet you. Enjoy your night.
You too. Thank you very much.
The Sturt guys are lovely. See, this is what I'm saying at every table, though. I'm going to say that when we go to the next table, but congratulations to these guys. So much premiership glory. Now, we're going to continue walking, actually. I'm going to go over to the Eagles table. I think we have a medalist here. I think Jarrod Petrenko's here. So I'm going to see if Jarrod wants to talk. Pup, have you said that you're going to talk or not? This is live on the stream, so I don't know if you want to talk or not. Jarrod Petrenko, football superstar and media's Jarrod Petrenko. How are you going, mate?
Yeah, I'm all right, thanks. How are you?
Yeah, going really well, thank you. The Eagles doing incredible things on the weekend, mate. You were out there, obviously, and you got to come back towards the end of the season. But I was saying earlier, having a look at the way that you boys played, to see the oldest man in football, Paul Stewart, doing some good things, but then going to one of the youngest men in football, young Lukosius, It shows that you boys have a lot of depth and a lot of growth for the future.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. It's that exciting to play with blokes like that. And I think for Luko to have guys like Stewie around him to, I suppose, support him and show him the ropes a little bit is awesome. And Luko's obviously got a massive future ahead of him. So, it was awesome by the whole team on the weekend. Loved it.
Is it one of those things that let's get the most out of Luko before he leaves and goes somewhere else?
Yeah, oh, 100%. Well, I think everyone's sort of making jokes that he's not actually going to nominate and he loves the Eagles that much and he'll stay with us. But, we don't have too much longer left with him. So hopefully we can send him off with a good win at the end of the year.
Made a joke about Paul Stewart. Obviously, we love him. If you're expecting another child on the way, so he'd be stressing about having two kids because having one is full on, trust me. Luke Thompson as well, one of the leaders of the club. And I also found out how to pronounce a captain's name correctly because everybody was going Gefreda, but it's Jafreda.
Yeah, well, I thought it was Gefreda, so you won ahead of me there. But no idea, but it's a good group.
Just finally, how many Instagram followers have you increased since being on television and becoming more of an absolute superstar than you are?
I don't know, mate. It's, trust me, that doesn't mean a thing to me. Anyway,
It's Boydie's night tonight. I'm here for Boydie.
Can I ask a question about Boydie? Actually, you don't have to answer this. I heard a rumour. Now, correct me if this... Just tell me if this is right or not. Is there some sort of tan that happens before televised games?
Yeah, oh, well, I don't know. I don't know where he's travelling to, but there must be a bit of sun happening around there the day before a game, so...
I need to ask this question. Boydie, can you confirm or deny you get a tan before televised games on Channel 7 for the sample?
No, I can strongly deny. No, I haven't had one this year. Past years, maybe.
So basically, you've just said, no, not this year, but every other year.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Guys, enjoy your meal. Thank you very much for giving us some time. I'm going to walk over, actually, and have a chat to a young Magarey medalist. I'm talking about Kai over here. Now, Kai spoke earlier, but he's a pretty shy guy. Kai, quick chat. How are you, mate? I'm going to only chat very briefly. And am I saying your surname correctly? Is it Pudney or Pudney?
Pudney.
Pudney, fantastic. You must be pretty proud, mate, not only winning the medal that you did, but also state representation and getting the win.
Yeah, it was good. So it was a pretty exciting year. So it's been good fun.
You play with a lot of incredible young talents for that South Australian side that I'm sure you've all got around.
Yeah.
What are some of the names that you think are going to go high in the AFL draft?
Probably Luco and Isaac Rankin. Yeah, that'll be the two probably.
You mentioned on stage earlier, and you did make an incredible speech. The coaching staff of not just the state team, but also the Eagles doing incredible things for you and your growth. Tell us about the club and what it means to you.
Yeah, it means a lot. They give me a lot of help. They help me out with my how to improve, areas improvement, especially Shane Reardon. He does a lot of work with me.
Just wanted to say, finally on stage, Mark Soderstrom, you'll be able to see on the broadcast later on, asked you about your long hair and if you get a little bit of stick for it. Mate, you can see my hair. Hold on to your hair as long as possible. Right. Do what you want with it. Ponytail, plaits, braids, afro, cornrows, I don't care.
Yeah.
Because you might turn out like me one day, and you don't want to do that, do you?
Nah, not really.
Great, awesome. You're supposed to say yes. Mate, congratulations. Enjoy the rest of the count. See, we're walking around. It's brilliant. All right, we're going over this way. Marty Matner, apparently, the head coach of the Sturt Football Club, is really excited to talk to me. G'day, Marty. How are you, mate?
Good, mate. How are you?
Good. Thank you very much for taking the time to have a chat. Now, I spoke to you pre-game on the weekend in the final, which didn't really work out. So I kind of feel that I've put the mocker on you boys. But I said to Zane Kirkwood earlier, that doesn't face Sturt too much because you've been in this position before.
Yeah, so we won't be doing it this weekend. But, the boys have been in that position before. And I think it's last year we lost the first final and then won three in a row. So it's not anything new to us, but it's going to be a big challenge this week.
Your depth is going to be tested as well, because there's a couple of injuries. You guys have been riddled with injuries all year, but to be in this position and still have such an incredible opportunity, it talks about the guys that really provide a lot of depth and strength for this club.
Yeah, it does, and hopefully we keep the team that we got on the weekend and maybe add Aiden Riley who's trying to train this weekend. Hopefully we can add someone like that, and Fraser Evans still a chance as well. So hopefully things work out for us this weekend.
How are you feeling? I said to Zane Kirkwood earlier that you are pretty much the most sought-after name in football at the moment when it comes to coaching. I don't want you to say too much because obviously your attention wins Sturt, but it must make you feel pretty good to go that you are doing all the right things.
Yeah, well, I guess, coming to Sturt a couple of years ago, we just tried to implement a plan and a structure that worked, and it has worked. And, the success of the footy club has been great at the moment. And last year to, I guess, win both all three grades is a great testament to both the club and the players and the staff of the footy club.
Who is going to be accepting the 2018 Magarey medal?
I don't know. We just haven't chatted before. I think it's probably one of the Norwood boys will be up there. Nick Little's not too bad. Zane always polls well. He loves the umpires and gives them a wink and a nudge every now and then. So I think he'll do well. But, it's hard to go past a couple of the Norwood boys and Nick Little, I think.
All right, mate. We'll let you get back to your meal. It looks like the steak is medium rare, which is fantastic. You're always so giving with the time with the SANFL, and especially tonight. So all the best on the weekend.
Thank you very much.
Marty Matner, head coach of Sturt. I've got my clipboard here. We're walking around. So what we might do is take a little bit of a break and have a look around the room, and we are going to chat to some more people very soon. This access is incredible. Have a look around. We'll see you shortly, this live stream.
Years in a jailer's eyes, thinking about my baby, looking as my life goes by. Falling in the streets of Rome, laughing at the blind man's eyes.
Thank you.
this is very exciting. The man of the moment, Nick Little. Now, we mentioned earlier that the umpires love him because of his flaming red hair. You always poll in the votes, mate, and you don't look too nervous tonight, obviously, drinking a West End, and he's loving it. Just hold your hand over that branding. We are loving West End here at the Magarey tonight. Lids, do you get nervous on nights like this?
Not at all. I enjoy coming and have a look at the count and see who polls, and it's got to get good to get around everyone and have a few beers.
Disappointing. Of course, West End, major sponsor of the SANFL. Thank you, and the Hall of Fame, and the West End State team. He's drinking West End. Responsibly, of course. Not the way that you wanted the season to end over the weekend. A great end to the season for the Panthers, but just, I've been mentioning all night, such a frustrating end because there was a couple of key errors towards the end of the game defensively, and no one was kicking goals at the Northern end. What do you take away from it?
Yeah, it was pretty frustrating. Look, we'd beaten North twice throughout the year. We felt really confident going in, but when it mattered, North got the point, so full credit goes to them. But look, there's a lot of things we'll look at. We're pretty frustrated with the result, but these things happen with footy.
Who's your tip to win tonight?
I think Grigor Panos will probably take it out. They're probably the hot favourites. Jarrod Chiller also. You could probably list there a few other guys, but I think Grig and Panos are the ones to beat.
Did you want to introduce your partner to us for the stream?
I can. Jess is
also drinking West End.
Yeah.
Hey, Jess, how you going?
West End's my favourite.
Thank you so much. Now, who are you dressed by tonight?
It's actually an online company. It's just a hire company.
eBay?
She has no idea. That's the...
It's actually Gumtree. Have you heard of that?
I have heard. I've actually tried to sell things on Gumtree before and I've stuffed it up. It is actually mine. No, you look absolutely beautiful. Now, your partner's very relaxed. He's just chilling out with his West End, of course. You think he's going to do very well, right, in the polling?
I think he's going to do really well. However, I think there may be a few people that do better than him.
What I love about a partnership is confidence in your partner. And
No, I think he'll do well, but I just think most Nord boys, you can't split them. Yeah.
All right, well, you guys enjoy the night. We very much appreciate you giving us your time. Mate, all the best for a little bit of the off-season. Apparently, I've heard rumours he's going to be hanging out with Matthew Burgess, just continually. He used to live together, right?
I was going to say, he put you up with this. I saw that on Facebook today, didn't he?
He said, go and talk to the man with the best personality in the SANFL. So I'm going to do that in a second. Mate, thank you very much.
See you, mate.
Thank you very much. Great personalities we do have here at the South Adelaide Football Club. I'm going to come and sit here in a second, actually. Cameraman, I'm going to sit on this chair. So I'm just going to sit right here. I'm just next to a couple of absolute superstars. Media's Alice James and also Joel Cross. Can you just turn around? Is that all right? Sorry. I'll speak to you in a second, Crossy, if that's all right. Alice, who's dressing you tonight?
A designer called Cole Jitters.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's actually my dad's friend. It's a cheap dress from online.
That's a good name drop as well. How are you feeling about your partner tonight? He always does well when it comes to polling votes.
Yeah, a bit of a quiet year. I reckon Leeds will take all of them, but he'll do all right. He does all right.
How many Magarey's have you been to?
This is my eighth. Yeah.
Eight. Okay, so do you have a plan? Do you have a couple of quiet pre-drinks responsibly, West End, of course, and then you go, great, we're just going to have a brilliant night, because obviously he's a little bit upset with what happened over the weekend.
Yeah, he's not that happy. He's been a bit depressed. I have a couple of drinks, but I can't pace myself. Like, once I have a couple of drinks, then I'm, like, crazy. So.
Okay, now, also, how do we follow you on Instagram?
Alice K. James.
All right, if you follow Alice K. James on Instagram, she fell off a chair the other day while working at Triple M. It's fantastic. It's gone viral. Give us one thing that I can ask Joel that will fire him up a bit in a happy way.
Ask him about his dog. We've got a dog called Bruce, and he treats it like a baby, and he walks around the house like holding it like a baby, singing to it.
Do that. Alice, thank you very much for your time.
Thanks, Jarrod.
All right, I'm going to come over here and talk to Crossy. Crossy, sorry to interrupt, mate. Okay, yes or no, dogs are better than kids?
Oh, yes. Hold on. Other people's children, I don't have any of my own, so it's hard to judge, but I love my dog like a child, yeah.
Tell us about Bruce.
He's a beautiful little dog. He's quite smart. Just a lovely little friend. Yeah.
Okay, I've got a golden retriever that I said to my wife, never ask what I love more because you'll be disappointed with the answer. And the dog sleeps under the covers in my bed and I spoon her and everything. And are you kind of like that with Bruce?
Yeah, absolutely. It'd be hard to see a child being loved more than Bruce, absolutely, yeah.
How old's Bruce?
He's about probably three or four.
If you smell Bruce's paws, they'll smell like buttered popcorn or Doritos. That is an absolute fact.
I'll try that tonight.
Serious football question. I was saying to Lids earlier, who's just drinking a fine West End, obviously. Disappointing end to the season, but a lot of good signs, especially towards the back end for South Adelaide.
Yeah, absolutely. We had some young guys on the weekend who probably got their first run around on Adelaide Oval. Probably their first run's on Thursday at the training session. Their second run was the game on Sunday. So pretty inexperienced lineup, but really great for them to have a run around. And I think there's a lot of positives to South Adelaide in the future.
There is a huge part of me that wants Nick Little to win tonight, because I have a feeling his speech is going to be something that we remember for the rest of our lives. Do you agree?
Absolutely. I've seen him do 4 best and fairest speeches, probably 5 this year. So they're all terrific, and I'm sure they'll be even better here.
Fantastic, mate. Thank you very much for your time. Big shout. Oh, do you want to give a shout out to Bruce? He might be watching.
No, I don't think Bruce is. He might. G'day, Bruce. Good to see you, buddy.
Thanks, guys. Very much appreciate your time. Alice James and also Joel Cross from South Adelaide. We're walking around. Where are we going? I don't even know where we're going. We're being pointed in this direction, so let's just keep coming around this way. The food is incredible at the time. Josh Carr. We've got to go find Josh Carr. Oh, here he is right here. Kari's right here. And I'm going to sit in between Kari and also Max Stream. G'day, Kari. Now, mate, I spoke to you briefly before the start of the game on the weekend, and you said we're going to come out firing, and you did. You guys went pretty full on, and you got the win. How are you feeling?
Yeah, obviously it was fantastic to get the result. The boys came out, probably not the first quarter, but the second quarter, put in some good pressure around the ball, and obviously to get the win off the back of some pretty lean years was good.
There was a period during the game where I think even a runner got started to get a little bit verbal. I don't want you to comment on that, of course, but first final since 2013. I mentioned that the reserves are doing really well. Jacob Surgeon taking all the credit for that, obviously. But going into this weekend, you play that style of football as well. It's only going to mean great things for the Roosters.
Yeah, definitely. Sturter, you know, they've won 2 flags in a row. So off the back of losing on the weekend, they're going to be pretty fired up. There's no doubt that we have to play our best, not for 2 quarters. For 4 quarters, so that's what we're going to have to deliver.
Is that what it felt like on the weekend? Because that's what it looks like. Both teams played 2 quarters of solid footy, and you just played the better 2 quarters.
Yeah, a little bit. You know, South's third quarter especially was they upped the tempo, and we're very good. And the first quarter was probably a little bit of just seeing how each other were going to go. And great game of football.
Thank you very much, Curry. Maxi, speaking to you at the end of the game, it seemed just pure elation from a club point of view, from a personal point of view. You know the job's not done, but a sigh of relief that you've got that final.
Yeah, definitely. You know, we went in there with a plan, and I thought we executed it pretty well. They came at us for, you know, 1 or 2 quarters, but we held them off, and happy days.
All right, that is the most serious answer I've had tonight. Let's talk about Mitch Harvey, because obviously he's all over social media. The big red, like the really big red, who just scores goals for fun, he seems to be the type of guy that would be reminding everybody that he is capable of that kind of stuff, even though it was just a quarter.
Yeah, he's pretty loud out there, mate, and pretty big, as you can see. But he played fantastic quarter, and that's all he did, really. So 1 quarter of footy these days for big halves.
It did turn the game, though, especially with how the game was going, and it just seemed to happen so quickly because of how saying to Kari that it was definitely a game of 2 quarters for each side. So all we need is that from him.
That's right. You know, thank God we had him, because he was clunking everything. So I think he kicked 4 goals that quarter. Just really happy for him.
Was there an intended aggression to go into the game with? Because it certainly seemed like that against South Adelaide. And if you take that against Sturt this weekend, that will be even better.
Yeah, you know, like first half of the season, we sort of brought that hunt and that angry behaviour, and we brought that on Sunday, and we got the win. So, yeah, we'll be bringing that this Sunday for sure.
Keen to next year. He's on Tinder at the moment. On Snapchat. Mate, you kicked a cracker goal on the weekend as well, so well done.
Oh, thanks, mate. Yeah, no, it was good to get on there.
Who are you Snapchatting?
It's actually a little group, Rooster Snapchat, so taking photos of these boys and they're carrying on a little bit.
What's your favourite Snapchat filter that you use?
They changed, but probably the dog one, that hangs around. I think the girls love it as well, so.
There's a funny one on Snapchat at the moment, which is a thumb, and I don't need it because obviously look like a thumb, so I don't actually need to. Have you used that one?
No, I haven't, but it sounds like you're pretty efficient on the old Snapchat. So.
No, I've never used it. I'm married, mate. See you guys. Thanks for the chat. That was really awkward. Thanks. The boys from North Adelaide, they are up and about. I'm going over this way now.
Oh, this is actually very exciting to Jacob Templeton, the reserves, Mary Geddes and Magarey. Oh, I tell you what, mate, I feel like I've played four quarters of footy. I'm sweaty. You can see my bloody head just glistening with sweat. Congratulations. That was James Rowe that you beat in the reserves, Magarey, right?
Yeah, just by one vote. So we played each other in the last round too, so I must have just got him in the last game.
I was talking to Trent Goodrum earlier about the disappointment of Centrals in, of course, the SANFL not making the finals, but you guys doing quite well to keep that club alive. Personally, how proud are you of your performance, but also of the club?
I didn't really think about winning the league medal or anything. There wasn't until a couple of rounds to go that a couple of the boys sort of started joking about it, that I might be in with a sniff, and it came out on the end. So confidence on my end was pretty high. We've been lucky enough to have a fair few senior guys come back into the team at the end of the season, plus a few young guys came back, a few draft prospects, Jackson Haley and Ches McLennan. So we've got quite a strong team. We snuck in at fifth, but we're feeling pretty confident. So, yeah, it's good. Hopefully we can push a bit further in the finals.
Is this what you do? You take this now into the coach and you go next year, now this is my senior collar, mate?
Yeah, I might wear it for a little while.
I just noticed, who's this next year?
This is Kyle Presbury.
All right, so Kyle Presbury is doing the Dele Alli, trying to do that thing. Now, can you do that? Because it's really weird how you can do that. And I've kind of worked it out, because people do that with their thing. But if you move your hand like that, I can almost do it. Can you do it?
I've never even tried.
You try it. Try it. Go on.
No, I'm no good.
Mate, this is live television going all around the world.
No, I'm no good.
Just give it. Just show us how your attempt. Just your attempt. Yeah, that was so worth it. Hey, guys, that was awesome. Hey, thank you very much. Congratulations, Jacob. Now, don't forget, 9 o'clock on 7, mate, we are going to be showing the live coverage of the Magarey as well. I don't even know. Oh, here's the water. Oh, I'm so hydrated. All right, I'm going to go have a water with Mitch Grigg. Where is he? Oh, he's over here. Is there? Sorry, I shouldn't put my back to the camera, but I'm so dehydrated. So I'm going to go to a man who's actually going to try and win his second consecutive Magarey medal. Hey, Mitch! I'm so dehydrated. Hey, mate. You all right, mate? Great to see you. Did you get a spray tan for tonight?
No, actually, I had a quite little trip to Port Douglas about a month ago, so I got enough glow from that.
All right, talk to me. We'll talk football in a second. Your trip to Port Douglas, I just don't want to sit on that bloke's shoulder behind me because it'd be really weird.
It's just Michael Tarley, that's all right.
Port Douglas, whereabouts did you stay?
We stayed at the QT.
Okay, I'm really glad you said that, because now we're not sponsored by the QT Hotel or anything. We're sponsored by West End, and everybody's drinking West End responsibly tonight. The QT buffet is one of the best in the world, yes or no?
Yeah, it was really good, actually. Gave it a workout most mornings. It was really good, really nice to get away for a weekend and just relax.
Mate, how satisfied are you at the moment that everybody's saying you're going to win this one? I don't want you to comment too much about your own personal performance, because I know you and you're a very modest man, but to be in this position, especially after last year, to be in the running to win it 2 years in a row?
It's humbling to think that people might think I'm a favourite, but I think my fellow teammate, Matty Panos, has had a little bit more polish this year than I have, so I'm rooting for him tonight, that's for sure.
There's a chance you're going to take votes off one another, though, so are you going to be watching this with a keen eye, hydrating on all of your waters, and you'll be watching every game knowing, well, I should have got a couple of votes in that game and Matty shouldn't have?
Yeah, well, I can't actually remember which games I played well in, so, I suppose we're just obviously hydrating this week, but we're just looking forward to finals, to be honest.
After this weekend, of course, you've got the big game against the Eagles. Are you going to be playing against some of your former Crows teammates? You had a look at them on the weekend to see what they did to Sturt, because it was a fascinating game to watch.
Yeah, I mean, their pressure was really good, and Sturt were a bit slow with their ball movement, so hopefully we can go straight back at them and use our ball use. Hopefully we're on, and hopefully it's all good.
Personally, for yourself, with such successful seasons, two in a row, those ambitions to get back into the AFL, they're still there?
Yeah, obviously it's an ambition of mine, like you said, and something I'd definitely like to do if it was to happen, but I'm not counting my chickens as I hatch, because, you know, if something's going to happen, you know, it'll happen, but if not, I'm happy where I am.
All right, well, I think you're a beautiful man. You look great tonight. You've got a fantastic Northern Queensland tan. All the best, and we might be seeing you on the stage. It'd be great if you both won it together, right?
Yeah, that'd be unbelievable, so, but I don't think it'll happen. I think he'll get the win, but yeah, that'd be awesome.
All the best, mate. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Walsh.
Mitch Greig, an absolute legend, last year's Magarey winner. So we're going to walk around. Actually, I'm going to go to the big man, Jake Parkinson. He is the big boss of the SANFL. So let's go this way. Mark, our cameraman, doing an amazing job because he hasn't tripped over anybody tonight. Keep walking back. People enjoying their main course. Now, don't forget, at 9 o'clock, we are going across the live coverage as well. It's brilliant. All right, I'm walking across to Jake Parkinson now. There's something you may not know. Don't, Mark, you're going to walk into 10 people, mate. Don't knock over Petrenko and Luke Thompson. You can't do that. Do you see that? The cameraman almost knocked them out. I mean, Sturt have injuries. You can't take two out. All right, we're coming over to Jake. Come over this way. This is a big dog. Hello, Jake. How are you?
How are you?
Very well, thank you.
What a wonderful evening. Don't you look smart?
Thank you so much. Who stressed you?
I dressed myself. Yeah, I got up this morning, dressed myself a couple of times actually today.
We were having a look around and just commenting earlier of how beautiful the room looks. The SANFL team have put on an amazing job for the 2018 Magarey Medal and West End SA Hall of Fame.
It is a beautiful room, and everyone's scrubbed up really well. And yeah, Liz does a wonderful job of this and puts a lot of time and effort in, and I think everyone's appreciated it tonight.
It's been a really good season. We started off at the parade with SANFL Fast Footy, just something a little bit different in the pre-season, which was a great weekend, and then the season's flown. I was talking to Zane Kirkwood earlier that the season has flown, and here we are with some fascinating finals to look forward to, not only last weekend, but leading into this weekend as well, because you almost can't pick a favourite.
Really tight contest, Walshy. We've got you know, that first final on the weekend, South-North, what an absolute crackerjack game that was, up and down the ground, and then a really tight, hard-fought game, the Eagles-Sturt game. So it would be interesting to see, with Norwood coming in, you know, they come from a smaller home deck, what they're able to do on the big surface out here at Adelaide Oval, taking on the Eagles, who are really good at being able to shut good sides down. And, you know, supreme midfield there with the red legs. And then we'll see what can happen with certain North Adelaide. And I really enjoyed seeing how many North Adelaide supporters came out over the weekend. Fantastic attendance. So it'll be a really good weekend of footy.
Magarey Medal tonight, but also we are inducting some people into the South Australian Football Hall of Fame, which is a really special night for the legends of South Australian football.
Look, that's the wonderful thing about tonight, is you've got the modern-day player who's here for the Magarey Medal, but when you walk around the room, you see some of those West End Hall of Fame guys. There are some absolute luminaries of South Australian football. We'll have three more of those added tonight, and I always enjoy listening to them tell their stories, and we'll have some great chats tonight, no doubt.
Yeah, of course, I know you, Jake, extremely well from the Grange Royals Hockey Club. You're a very humble man, but one of the best hockey players I have ever seen. Out of 10, how would you rate me? Because I played like a newborn giraffe. I was all arms and legs, really struggled. Where would you put me?
Oh, look, Walshy, I saw you in your very formative years. I'm considerably older than you. I'm led to understand you really grew into that giraffe body. I did see the giraffe body early, and I'd put you right up there. You're at least a 7.
Thank you very much. A 7 out of 100 is brilliant. Jake, thank you very much for your time. You come from a brilliant family, the Parkinsons, and congratulations on another successful year for the SANFL. We love local footy. We love everything that the SANFL is doing, and a couple more finals.
Look, thanks for coming along. Thanks for adding some fun and colour. And, yeah, we look forward to seeing as many people out there on Sunday.
Awesome, mate. Thank you very much, Jake Parkinson. I'm going to shake your hand, mate, because I love it. I love this guy. Thank you. All right, let's come around this way, actually. Zach Milbank is back here. Here he is. Oh, sorry. I think I've just broken a bloke's shoulder.
G'day, Jarrod.
Zach, here we are.
I'm
out of breath.
How are you going? You worked up a sweat yet?
No, it was brilliant, mate. You know what I love? How giving the players are.
Fantastic.
I think sometimes in sport, some players don't want to talk, but I'm not just talking about any players. These are the leaders of their football clubs that continually want members and supporters to come out and watch them. The coaches are giving of their time, and I think they know what they need to be doing to help promote the game, because right now, we have a look around tonight, it's a celebration of state football, local football, which we never
never want to lose sight of. That's why we're here.
Exactly right, Jarrod. And you'll find with all the SANFL players, coaches, support staff, they actually love the attention. They'll be very forthcoming. They just do anything you ask them to do, which for us in the media is absolutely gold, isn't it?
It's brilliant. And I have noticed a couple of things. Zane Kirkwood is just relaxing. Schiller...
He's not on edge?
No, not on edge. Because he knows what to expect.
He's been there, done that.
Schiller, the same.
Is so, he?
Yes.
Okay.
But there's some notable people. Mitch Grigg.
Got a bit of sweat on their brow.
Grigg's nervous.
Grigg, is he?
Because I think he really...
But he's been there, done that.
He has, but he wants Panos to win.
Oh,
and I think
okay.
He's nervous because he's such a humble bloke that I reckon if he wins, he wants Panos to win. And then there's Little, who's drinking a West End, and he's going to give a Dane Swan-like speech.
Is he really? Well, I look forward to that greatly. Has he got notes from Crossy on how to do it, Joel Cross?
Joel is talking more about his dog, Bruce.
Oh, Bruce. How's Bruce going?
Yeah, Bruce is really good. He said he loves Bruce more than any other human, and it got a bit weird, so I kind of walked away from the table.
Yeah, I'm sure that went down well with Lids then, because yeah, they're good buddies.
Yeah. Look, mate, thank you for everything tonight. We're going to cross to the coverage very soon, bud. It's been brilliant just to walk around and talk to these people and talk about local footy. You do an outstanding job covering it. You continually have. So you can enjoy the night now, and we'll throw to the coverage soon.
Thank you for your promotion on your Twitter page and throughout the night. Done a great job, Jarrod. Cheers, mate.
Awesome. We'll have another look around the room and we'll say farewell very shortly before we throw it back to Mark Soderstrom. Well, ladies and gentlemen, our guitarist has just finished, so we are minutes away from the Hall of Fame presentation. You can keep watching the stream for that, but if you do want to watch the count of the 2018 Magarey Medal, make sure you turn it to 7 Mate at 9 o'clock. It's going to be fantastic. Who will take it away tonight? Will it be Mitch Grigg, two in a row? Will it be Nick Little? It could be Travis Schiller or Matt Panos from Norwood. We will find out shortly. Thanks to everybody for watching the stream tonight. We tried to do something a little bit different and give you insight into what was going through the players' minds, their partners on the red carpet, the extremely hard-working team from the SANFL have put tonight together. So very much appreciate you having me as your host. My head is really shiny, I know. We will see you very soon. Good luck to everybody with the rest of the night. Thank you for watching and keep on supporting local South Australian football.
Thank you. Hello again, everyone. I trust that you've enjoyed your main course. We are about to do our Hall of Fame inductions. So could I ask you please to make your way towards your tables, only because we're on a bit of a tight time schedule. Isn't that right, Richard Allen? Exactly. So if you can make your way back to your tables, there'll be plenty of time to chat and network and catch up, swap old stories as we go along in the evening. All righty. I'm going to start using names. That works better, doesn't it? Johnny Cunningham. How are you, mate? Sit down, please. Gotcha. It works quick. John Kernahan, take a seat, please. I've got another one. Who else can we pick off? Oh, now, these boys are coming from training. That's okay. They're still in the competition. All the Roosters, the North Adelaide boys just finished training. Welcome along. Good to see you, boys. Obviously, a terrific win for the Roosters on the weekend in the elimination final. They'll be taking on Sturt on Sunday in the second game. First game. And then Norwood and the Eagles in the second game. All righty. Thank you, everyone, for getting back to your tables. All right. Thanks again to the Happy Leonards. Well, the West End South Australian Football Hall of Fame enshrines those who have made the most significant contribution to the game of Australian football here in SA. The Hall of Fame was established in 2002. 114 people were inducted in the inaugural induction. Since then, there's been a range of other players, administrators, media members, umpires even. And there's a nice couple of tables of umpires. Welcome along, guys. You don't often get acknowledged. You normally just get a bit of lip and some abuse, so we're going to be kind to you guys tonight as well. The Hall of Fame is going to invite three more into the fold tonight, all outstanding contributors to our game here in South Australia. So without any further ado, let's get into this year's inductions to the West End SA Football Hall of Fame. Just some amazing vision there, some amazing names, and many of the gentlemen in the room we've already seen tonight. Liz, bear with me for a moment. I'm going to break with tradition just here for a moment. Can I just get everyone who is already inducted in the Hall of Fame to please stand up, because I think it's important that we recognise all of you, because there are many that are here tonight. So all the people that have already been inducted, please stand up. Stephen Kernahan, I can see you. You should be standing up. Who else is... Timmy Ginever over there, Lee Wicker, Neil Curliers, Chris McDermott, as I'm looking around. Fantastic to have all of you guys here with us tonight. Timmy Pfeiffer, Bill Sanders, everyone. Good on you guys. Congratulations, John Helbert, Phil Gallagher. It's like a who's who. It's like just reading out all the footy cards we'd have had as a kid, just all of those names. Let's find the first person that is going to join those greats. Skillful and lively player boasting unbelievable pace. 308 games, and he's the only player at his club to reach the 300-game milestone. Of course, talking about the man known as Milky, Peter Vivian. Central's best and fairest in 78, chosen on the wing in the Bulldogs' best all-time team, which was put together from 64 to 2003. I'd like to get everyone to have a look up at the screen. Let's have a look at Pete in action, and then we'll welcome him up to the stage.
Two comes Vivian. Vivian ducking and diving. Goes through, bounces the ball once. He's trying to get himself lined up in front. He does so. He's too quick, this player.
Through comes Vivian. Gets the kick on the way. I think it's going to go. Oh, great goal from the wingman.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Peter Vivian. Good on you, Pete. Congratulations. John Olsen. Just get the obligatory photos. Everyone's nice and quiet again. It's like the Vice Regal salute. Great to see the old white Doggies jumper too, which we would have seen over the last few weeks in Retro Round, which was a great initiative of the SANFL. Hello, Pete. How are you going?
Good, thanks, mate.
Pop up here, mate. You're front and centre now. Congratulations.
Thank you.
What a brilliant honour. The only Doggie that has played the 300. In most recent times, I've seen a couple of Gowans boys up the back there. They tell me they were the two greatest dogs of all time, but I think you certainly should be right up there, Pete. Tell us about being inducted. When you found out, what were your first thoughts?
Well, I was a bit surprised, and I must confess, maybe 2 or 3 years ago, I thought I might have a chance, and then I sort of thought they've overlooked me. It's an honour and it's a pleasure to be involved in a group of players that are in the group now.
Pete, tell us about, as a young man from Mount Pleasant, coming down to the footy club, as a new footy club, tell us what it was like, your first memories.
Look, I think Central started in 1964 and I got there in 1969. And I started in the under-19s and Chris Grant was my ruckman in the under-19s. I remember if you're going to get a kick off his ruck work, you're over to the opposition ruck. I played, I think, 8 games, the under-19s, went through to the reserves, played the last few games in the league side. From then on, I was probably a regular, but it was an exciting time because we were starting to build and a couple of years we'd played in some finals for you, yep. So it was a good time to be involved in the club.
Finals, of course, in 71 when you made them, Sturt had been pretty impressive with their 5 flags in a row and you guys stopped them. You were one of the best players in that 27-point win, just out there on that deck. Memories of that day?
Yeah, it was it was a great day, and I think the crowd was about 28,000, and I remember that Tony Cassidy made us run the first lap and the warm-up right close to the boundary, so we're near to the spectators, and it was an exciting game, and a great game for us to win. I remember playing on Michael Graham that day, and Michael and I had many a fine tussle over our careers, so it was the start of a sort of a bit of an era for us. We unfortunately dropped off a bit later in the mid-70s, but it was a great time to be involved.
For guys like yourself that spent so much time at the club, when we saw the change in 2000 and it was just unbelievable playing in those 12 grand finals in a row, What was it like as one of the earliest players at the club to actually see such sustained success for such a long time there?
Oh, I think you wished you were 20 years younger and still involved, but, but it was great for the club. And look, the club had worked so hard to get to a position like that, and recruiting the two Gowans boys and some other people really added some excitement to the club, and it was great for the club and it was great for the area and fantastic for the players to be involved at that time.
Pete, just before I get you to thank some people, because I'm sure there are many you'd like to acknowledge, I just want to ask you about coaching. Now, you were coaching the twos at the club for a while. I want to go back to a game in 1994, and Alan Stewart was the league coach, and he was crook. So you got the call-up to be the Central District League coach. Now, where were you guys on the ladder around that time?
Mate, I can't remember that, but I remember Sturt were bottom. And
you were sort of near the top somewhere?
Yeah, we probably were.
And so the one, what happened, Pete?
Well, I guess the outcome was that Sturt had their first win for the season. And
yeah.
My record as a league coach is a zip and one. So, hence, I never got any further with the league coaching career.
Pete, 308 games. You are one of the all-time greats of Central District Football Club, one of the greats of South Australian football. Congratulations. I'm sure there's some people you would like to thank. And that's called payback from Chris Grant too, just so you know.
I suppose there's always somebody who remembers something bad about you. I guess first of all, thanks to the selection group that put me in this position. I know there's a great bunch of blokes involved there. But as I said, to be involved now with players like Curls and Barry Robber and Russell Ebert, it's a fantastic thrill and an honour. And I thank the South Australian Football Competition for giving me this honour. Also, I probably need to thank the Central District Football Club for the opportunity they gave me. And in particular, Chris Grant, because Granty was there when I started and he was there when I finished. And he was always a great support and a great friend, and he's been great for the Central District Football Club. I guess the other thing about playing football over 17 years, there's other people involved. Roxanne's always been a great supporter of mine, and while I was off having fun training with the boys and playing on Saturdays, she was home looking after the kids and changing nappies and doing that sort of thing. So she was an important part, as every wife is in the part of a footballer. So thanks very much for that, Roxanne. To my children, Kim Anthony and Sally Ann, the boys were only young when I was sort of getting towards the end of my career, but I've got no doubts that every Saturday in the grandstand they gave Roxanne a pretty hard time, but they also appreciated coming along to the footy and meeting all the players and being in the change rooms after the game. So thanks for that, guys. I think throughout your football life, there's many people that you meet in your own club and other clubs, and certainly, you know, if I go through the Central District Football Club, you know, the Lyle Skinners, the Ian Crones, the John Duckworths, the John Plattons, the Peter Joneses, great footballers, but also great people. If I go to other clubs, I remember in my first three games, I think it might have been in the first game, I played against Curls on the Adelaide Oval, and it was that game that I learnt that you had to be pretty quick, because if you weren't going to be quick, Curls might get you. But a lot of great players. I remember playing against Barry Robran and William in a state game or two, and he was just a fantastic person and a lovely bloke to know. And in football club in general, there's so many great people, and through my career at Centrals and when I coached up at Angaston and when I coached the All Central, there were just clubs full of fantastic people that wanted to do things for football in South Australia, and that's so important, what we have. So to those country clubs that I was involved in, thanks very much as well. It's most important. I did go back and coach at Centrals for 5 years in the reserves, and that was enjoyable. Alan Stewart had taken over, and I think to a certain extent we helped turn the club around and get them to the success level that they had in the early 2000s. So it's been a fantastic time, and I wouldn't change it for any money. And people say, you know, would you like to be playing now? Well, I suppose for the money you would, but for the fun and pleasure and the enjoyment that we had back between 69 and 85 when I played. You couldn't ask for a better time, so it was just fantastic. So thanks for that. But even outside of football, there are people that are so important to you in your life, and there's a lot of people that you can't put names on, the same as the people involved in footy. There's many, many inside footy, and there's people outside of football that have been important in my life. So I'd just like to thank everybody that's had some input into my life and the success in my, I guess, football career and business career. So thanks very much.
Congratulations to Peter. And of course, the Milky nickname lives on at the club because Luke Barmby, number 44, is also known as Milky. So there's a nice little touch that that nickname is continuing on. So congratulations, Pete. You join a great list of superstars. All right, let's get straight into our next inductee. Another 300 gamer, 343, in fact, in from 84 to 98. And only Russell Ebert has played more games for the Magpies than this man. Won the goal kicking at Port in 86 and 87 and played in just seven premierships. It's ridiculous, isn't it? All these Port Adelaide blokes. Seven premierships. It is amazing. One of the fittest and most reliable players, I think, that ever played South Australian football. Congratulations to Darren Smith. Ladies and gentlemen, please congratulate Darren Smith. Seven premierships, Darren. Should have been eight, shouldn't it? You know that. You're a naughty man. You belted someone. Cost you a flag, didn't it, Timmy G? Congratulations, mate. How you doing?
Not too bad. Not too bad.
That's all right. I know we say this whenever we're interviewing a Port Adelaide bloke, that you all have so many premierships. You're greedy, but you're all bloody successful, and it is remarkable. Do all seven still just remain really clear in your mind? Because I know for a lot of the guys they do, and some others just sort of, well, we just kept winning.
We had a reunion a few weeks ago for our 88.
You'd have one every year, wouldn't you?
Well, we can, but yeah, we'll worry about that. We had one for our 88 and 98 combined, and a few weeks ago, Timmy organised it, and I actually had to look at the video to see what we actually did. So I knew he won, but
So you don't remember every?
No, I'm not like Timmy. I haven't got a photographic memory, so yeah.
It's amazing, and I think Curls is a bit like that with his memory, and that you can. Guys can remember every match just about in every different moment. But you'd remember celebrating seven flags. It's just an amazing time of success for Port Adelaide that you're a part of.
Oh, exactly. We're very lucky to have a, well, obviously a very strong club, but a very strong group of players that you know, with a few extra good champions, either, you know, older ones come in from, or from interstate, or from young ones like a Buckley or a Wanganeen or a McLeod thrown in there, every, you know, when they started their careers. So I was very lucky to be able to play with players like that, you know, started off playing with Russell Ebert and Greg Phillips and Tim Evans and blokes like that, and yeah, and sort of finished my career playing with, you know, Warren Treadray and blokes like that. So, you know, it's I've been very, very lucky.
Darren, I've heard John Cale mention this, and he is obviously a very, very, very good judge of footballers. He said there are certain players that I would trust implicitly in a grand final, and he said they were players like Bruce Abernathy, Russell Ebert, Greg Phillips and Darren Smith, which is wonderful praise from one of the greatest coaches of all time, because everyone wants to play to win a flag, but he said that you were that reliable that he knew you would be the first picked in his side most of the time, which I reckon is just an unbelievable accolade and praise.
Yeah, well, Jack, obviously, with his record, just, yeah, everything. Well, actually, he was a very good card salesman, Jack, and he could actually get you to do things that you probably didn't think you could do. And but, yeah, he was a big, very big supporter of mine. And yeah, if it wasn't for Jack, I suppose, you know, Russell Ebert coached me early on in my career. And but, yeah, Jack was just brilliant for not just for myself, but for the team.
You were with the Crows at the start, and you're a Port Adelaide man with the Crows. What was it like there?
It was different. Like, there was obviously there was a bit of feeling towards Port Adelaide in general when, you know, obviously the Crows came about. The players in general were pretty good, but I think there was some feelings there. Reading Scott Hodges' book, I sort of had some things come back in that sort of bit related to me as well with the way we were treated. But look, I enjoyed my time there and made some really good friends and been to a couple of, you know, the 10-year and the 20-year reunions on those as well. And it's absolutely fantastic to catch up with those guys.
Now, I just want to clear something up here, because there's a bit of an urban myth about you at the Fire Brigade, because you're obviously in the Fire Brigade for many years. And I just need you to tell me whether it's fact or fallacy. So what happens is, for those, there's probably half the room are firemen because of they've been in the football fraternity. But in the Fire Brigade, if you want someone to cover your shift, it's called a standby, and you just get someone to cover you. And at one point, I think there were four of the nine SANFL coaches, when it was nine in there at that time, or ten, were firemen. So there were standbys left, front and centre. So long as someone covered your shift, it was fine. The bosses didn't really care. Now, is it true that you couldn't get a standby, and the boys still talk about this at the station, that you couldn't get a standby, so you called in sick, and all the boys are sitting there on the recliners just waiting to go out and save some lives, as do as firemen, and they're watching TV, and there's bloody Darren Smith running around playing football interstate. Now, is that a true story?
I don't know whether it was interstate.
Oh, was it home?
No, I did get in a bit of trouble when it was at the Crows Rapid Bay camp when Nigel Smart famously walked on the coals.
Oh, yes, yep.
It was that weekend, I think. I thought I'd had a standby, and it worked out I didn't. So
bloody Nigel, if he hadn't have burned his feet, you wouldn't have been spotted, would you?
Exactly. The TV cameras might not have been there, but I don't think so. They would have been there anyway.
Darren, congratulations, mate. Absolutely fantastic to see you in there. And one of the greats, not of just Port Adelaide Football Club now, but of South Australian football. I'm sure there's some people you'd like to thank.
Certainly like to thank the SNFL and the committee for the nomination and very humbling award this is. It's fantastic just seeing the guys that stood up before, just to see, you know, to have my name up with them guys is unbelievable. Something I've probably never thought of. I'm more of the team type person, but not the individual awards, but this is very much a great honour. Really like to thank my family, and my mum and dad and my two brothers and two sisters are here tonight, and thank them for making the effort to come over here. They had to travel to get here today. My two girls, Lisa and Kelly, absolutely fantastic, and I've actually got a very special girl here as well. My second granddaughter is 2.5 weeks old, and she made the effort of coming here too. So there she is up on the screen. Of course, I'd like to thank the Port Adelaide Football Club. They've been like a family to me. When I left to come off the farm, I told Dad that I'd be probably 2 years. 2 years and I'll be back on the farm, don't worry about it. 22 years later, I went home. It was a fantastic experience for me. It opened up a lot of doors in life and in business and in general. Made some fantastic friends and all the teammates, the support staff especially the last few years, got me through to keep playing and all the administration as well. Absolutely fantastic. Also to the Adelaide Football Club, thank you for the opportunity to play at the top level. And I enjoyed my time there, and it really was an experience, and to see how other coaches and clubs are run as well was a definitely experience. And also to play a bit of state football as well. I can remember playing with Styx Kernaghan at the MCG. It wasn't a very memorable day, but we got absolutely thumped. But when you've got a full forward line of Tony Lockett, Gary Ablett Senior and Dunstall, it was going to be very hard to win anyway. But that's how lucky I've been, that I've actually played with players like that, and the players I mentioned before, and the opponents that I've played against as well. It really has been a fantastic experience, and thanks for everyone that's had any part of my football life and life in general. Thank you very much.
Well done to Darren. Fantastic stuff there. We will go to our third and final inductee now, and another person that's coming up has been sitting there all night thinking, when am I having to come up to do this? Well, it is right about now. This man that is being inducted is one of the absolute greats of the Glenelg Football Club, not just as a player or in a coaching manner, but also as a general manager. He oversaw the really golden era of the Glenelg Football Club and helped build a formidable squad. He joined the Bays in 1959. He was a big ruckman, played 176 league games between 59 and 65, then again 69 to 71, and was a general manager for many, many years, as I mentioned, through the greatest phase of the Glenelg Football Club. And Darren just talked about that 1987 game with the star-studded South Australian and Victorian teams. Well, there was another game, I think, that's probably had an even boasted a better list of players. It was in 1963 when South Australia had that famous victory over Victoria. It was the first victory over Victoria since 1926 at the MCG by South Australia. Man who was playing that day is our next inductee, Harry Kernaghan. Please have a look up the screens.
Next year from Glenelg, the same sort of thing, we hope.
Look, the boys have got together. They've regrouped. There's a great side there at the moment. There's no reason why they won't go on with it.
That's good. And what's in store this afternoon?
Well, you better ask the young fellas, because as I said earlier, I'm wiser and older, and I know what I'll be doing.
Great that we can have a terrific representation of the Kernaghan family with us tonight, and son Stephen, who is already a member of the West End South Australian Football Hall of Fame, one of the inaugural members back in 2002, will be accepting the award on behalf of his dad. So please give Stephen a big welcome. Just while Stephen's doing that, that 1963 game, just to give you an idea, listen to some of these names. This was... The Victorian side had the likes of Baldock, Wade, Silvani, Skilton, Barassi, Kevin Murray, John Nichols, Polly Farmer, and the South Australian team, with some of the gentlemen in this room, Shearman, Bills, Eustace, Head, Halbert, Curley, Lindner, Motley, Cahill, Hammond. It is just ridiculous. The stars on both sides, including Harry Kernaghan. Steve, come and join me, mate. How you doing, Steve?
Good, Siders. How are you, mate?
Terrific, mate. Hey, great to see you here. You've got the whole family pretty much around there.
I have.
Both the brothers?
Yep. They've settled in well and early today, so they're going quite well over there.
Mate, what a great honour. Father, son. I think there's a bit of a Glenelg flavour because Graham and Chad Corns are in as father and son, and you and Harry. How great's that?
It was a bit emotional watching that when you see it on the screen there. And, Dad was a great Glenelg footballer, state footballer. Three sons played at Glenelg. Win a few flags under Dad. Three flags in his 20-odd year reign. We only won four, and I look at Darren Smith, won seven. It's unbelievable, isn't it? One bloke alone.
Quite amazing. Steve, tell us about your early memories of Dad as a footballer.
Well, Dad, well, I was a kid, obviously. Dad came from Port Augusta. His mum and dad came from Northern Ireland, lived up there, moved to Port Augusta, was born, played at South Augusta, came down to Torrens for a while, got the flick there, went to Glenelg. And I remember a kid watching him, got knocked out one day at Prospect as a kid, and 69 or 70 it would have been. After you come back from Wales, we had to go to Wales and play between 66 and 68. So, I thought it was dead. Mum, I was crying. He's dead, Dad. He's dead. He had blood all over him. So, those sort of memories go back. But, great memories of him, setting up the Glenelg Footy Club for what would be a great era.
He was a tough unit too, wasn't he? There's a game in Perth. He played with pretty much a broken shoulder and didn't come off the ground.
Yeah, he's lived off that for a while, so does he?
Everyone tells me.
I think it was 62. Kells was probably there. Foss Williams is the coach, though. I don't think you go off when Foss Williams coaches you or Curley coaches you. He said, Harry, you've got to stay out there, mate. He had a broken collarbone. And if everyone who's been in this room has had a broken collarbone, they're terrible. They're not good. They hurt hard. And he played the whole last quarter with one. And he kicked a point, he reckons. I don't know how you did that, Dad. But, they were great memories for him, the 63 win. He lived with that for years too, so to see.
Well, you should. Hey, that's an unbelievable list. Like, you got to play in some great State of Origin and state games, but just going through some of those names, that is just mind-boggling, having all that talent on one field in 63.
Yeah, well, they beat him in 26, but I've done a bit of homework on that 63 side. As the coming of South Australia, when all that great side had finally come across and beaten the Vics on their home turf, and that was when South Australian footy really became a force. And Dad, I think he doesn't give himself too many accolades, but when really pressed, he rucked against Big John Nichols and Polly Farmer, who are Hall of Fame legends, of course, in Australian football. And he says if pushed, he thought him and Bill Weddy just shaded him on the day, which is probably about right.
Steve, I'm going to break with tradition here for just a moment. You stay up here because I know you're very comfortable behind the mic in all the roles that you've had through football. So just stay here for a moment. Neil Curley is down here, and Curls has got a bloody good memory. So, Curls, can I just get you to stand up for a moment? I know. Don't swear. People can hear you. Stand up, please. Now, Curls, for those people that didn't get a chance, hang on, for those people that never got a chance to see Harry play, give us a bit of a description of what he was like.
Well, he was not a gifted player. He was a self-made player, and they're the players you want in the tough battles. He taught himself how to play footy. He was as tough as bloody hell, all raw and bones. Because I played against him a couple of times, and by the Jesus, he belted the shit out of me. but in that 63 game, he partnered Bill Wedding and did an unbelievable job because, as you say, the players you mentioned for Victoria, they had a super team. And I'll never forget because I was asked to go up on television. I'd never been on television before. On Friday night, and Harry Beitzel was a compere. And he said to Jack Dyer, he said, Jack, if you were coach of this Victorian team, what would you do? And Jack Dyer said, this is the best Victorian team I've ever seen selected. If I was coach, I'd give him a pep talk and go to the races. That's exactly what he said. Harry Beitzel turned to me and said, what do you think of that, young Curley? I said, well, everybody's entitled to their opinion. So I've gone back and the boys are having a coffee in that at the old St. George's pub at St. Kilda. And I said, did you hear what that prick said on television? I said, we'll bloody show him. We'll show him. And, of course, that got the boys excited and over-revved. And, we won the battle that day.
Just one more, Curls, and you can sit down and relax. Take us back out to that oval just behind you there, 1969 prelim final. I reckon Harry didn't have his lucky shorts on. What happened?
Well, Annette, his lovely wife, used to pack his bag religiously. And he got to the game, and we're all getting changed, of course. And no, I was non-playing coach, that's right. And Harry's gone to find his shorts, and she didn't put my bloody shorts in. I haven't got any shorts. A property man come over, so he had two pair, one was too tight, tightened up the balls a bit, and the other one was a bit floppy. So, anyway, he's gone out and played the last quarter, and we were in trouble, sorry. Three-quarter time, we're in trouble. And he's come into the three-quarter time bench, and I'm looking around, I'm searching for something to say, and I've seen, there's Harry, standing there with these floppy, baggy shorts on. I said, you, Kernahan, you're useless so-and-so. You not only look like a Sheila, you're playing like a Sheila. Get out there and do... Well, sorry, too loud? No,
just a politically correct type thing, but anyway, curls is a different time.
So he's coming across the ring, yeah. And two of the, Laurie Rosewarne and Kevin Parham, stopped him. And I said, he's after me. He wanted a piece of me. I said, don't take it on me, you big going. Well, he played an unbelievable game. So we got up and won, beat Sturt in the preliminary, got up and won. And I've gone in, Kevin Parham, I said, he's waiting for you. Ooh, so, shit, okay. So in I go. And there he is, sitting on the bench, smouldering. There was smoke coming out of his ears. So I've rushed, I said, well done, big fella. You're the only one that could have done it. Whew. That sold everything.
Neil Curley.
He was a great player.
Neil Curley, well done, mate. So, Steve, all the things that you'd heard about your dad being a tough unit, well, obviously very true, which is terrific.
He was a tough unit, I tell you what. A couple of the those early Glenelg sides in the early 80s when I was growing up with Chris McDermott and Tony McGuinness and Tony Simons, Gavin Walsh, used to shit ourselves on Monday morning after what we got up to on the weekend because Harry Kernahan always found out about it and had to sort it out. So, yeah, well done, Kells. Kells spoke at my dad's memorial, actually, and he didn't shut up then either. But well done, Kells.
Steve, I want to take you back now. As your dad being general manager, like you said, he'd obviously get into you and ask you what had gone on. So you're a young buck, and some of the names you mentioned there, and you probably throw in Duthie and Maynard and that as well, and you blokes would have been running amok. I want to take you back to 1982 Knight Premiership, right? You guys won?
Yeah.
You would have been, what, 19?
Yeah, 63, 19, yeah.
McDermott, about 19?
Yep.
Tony Simons, probably about 20?
A bit older, yeah.
So Wednesday, you've won the match, out on the source at the Bay Disco on a Wednesday night. Is this true?
For those young enough to know, the Bay Disco came in on Wednesday nights first. It became famous because of Sunday nights, but we never drank at all, ever, midweek. But we did that night, and when we got home very late, Jesus, against my religion to do it, but McDermott dragged me out. It's his fault.
Well, you were in a lot of different times back then. In McDermott's white Mazda Capella with a rotary engine that would have sounded like a lawnmower coming down the street.
We don't condone drink driving insiders, but of course I think he may have dropped us home that night, but the old man was waiting for us, don't worry about that, he'd give it to us hard. And I've seen that one before. We used to play State of Origin games on Tuesday nights in those days, and that was the only other time we drank during the middle of the week. And Dad was always waiting for us, it was usually daylight when we got home too, but he was off us that night for sure.
One more I just want to go before I'm sure you can hand over. And what I'd like to do for the moment, because we're going to do a photo on that, can you get your brothers up here?
Yep.
Bring the brothers
right
up. Yeah. Dave and Gary, would you like to come up? Because I think when we're going to do a photo, that obviously do that. As the boys are coming up, I've seen once this magnificent vision, 85, you guys won the flag. The day after you've won the flag, obviously your dad is general manager. You've gone into the TV studios of what was Channel 7. There's Andy Kay, he'll remember. What was Channel 10 then, I think, before the change of the 7 and 10 codes? And Max Stevens was there in a pink jumper with a mustache that looked like he was in adult movies. And all you blokes are just sitting there having a massive day on the source. And I don't think they ever did that ever again in the history of TV and winning premierships, because that was mayhem on live TV, wasn't it?
Well, it was. We hadn't had much sleep that night, and Barney and I had left the Glenelg Footy Club and gone straight to Channel 10 that morning. I think he might have driven again, which is a bit of a worry. But
not in the white Capella.
Those were the days. Those were the days.
The big day?
They were the big days.
Andy Kaye here is the boss of Channel 7, and I don't think he'll let anything like that ever happen nowadays. Mate, I'd like to hand over to you if you'd like to say some words, Stephen. Thought it's fitting to have both your brothers up here at the same time together.
Thanks, Siders. Firstly, congratulations to Peter and Darren. Well done, guys. Played against Peter and Darren, and great footballers in their right. And great to see them. It's a great night for their families. If my old man was up here, he was a good family man, great family man, looked after all of us three here, which is bloody difficult. He'd be thanking his mum and dad who came out from Northern Ireland. No wonder they're all mad, they come from there. He met a very nice lady called Annette Bowman from Corn. He's living in Port Augusta. If you've seen Dad in those early days with his glasses on, he was batting way above his average when he pulled Mum, I'll tell you. Mum was a good sort and Dad was struggling a bit in those areas. Dad had a great family, brothers and siblings. He had Zeke, Moo, Jim and Elaine. Don't know how Elaine went with those four boys, I'll tell you. It was dangerous up there in the early days in Port Augusta boys, I think. And then he thanked his three sons. He supported us, Mum and Mum and Dad were fantastic, never pushed us in anything, drove us everywhere we wanted to go. Footy in the winter and cricket and life saving in the summer. And I'd just like to say we've got Gary's wife Carmen here tonight and his son Todd and Billy's at the show tonight. We've got David and his lovely wife Catherine. We've got my lovely wife Jennifer Kernahan here. And we've got Uncle Moo, Dad's brother's son John here with Sally. And who else we got down there? Have I left anyone out? And of course, long-time Kernahan brother Chris McDermott, Bones, sitting there. He caused Harry Kernahan a shitload of trouble, let me tell you, he really did. And in finishing, I'd just say, probably later in life, Dad had a great life, had a lot of great mates in football. As a footballer, his teammates and his administration days, Big Bob McLean taught him everything he knew. Knows that, Big Bob, you know what that's about. Wally Miller and Chris Grant's been mentioned tonight. Dad had a great administration time with Glenelg, three flags. He went to South Adelaide at the end of his career, had a great 4 years there and got a grant and pushed him down to Noarlunga, where they're still there today. And I think Dad would just say our best times later in his life, before he passed away, was sitting with his mates, his three boys, having a beer at the back. Thanks very much. Thanks, Sid.
How are you, mate?
Fantastic. Great to have all the Kernahan boys up there. Well, that wraps up our three inductees for tonight. Congratulations to Darren Smith, to Peter Vivian and the Kernahan family in recognition of Harry. To give you a bit of an understanding, just before we go to a break also too, at 9 o'clock we're going to switch into the broadcast, so I'll keep you in the loop with how we're doing that and how that will roll. Before we do have this break, obviously, as we've acknowledged three greats of South Australian football and met many of the others tonight, there are some fantastic people that have been involved in South Australian football that have left us over this last year. So we'd like to pay tribute to those people on the screen.